Gillette, the best a man can get. And Panasonic, even more than you expected.
Tonight, it's the night for champions as Melbourne takes on Geelong in the grand final of the Panasonic Cup live from VFL Park. Melbourne finds itself in the final after several heart-stopping finishes, defeating Fitzroy and the West Coast Eagles by less than a goal. But the Demons are a team of fighters. Geelong, on the other hand, in two matches has an average winning margin of more than 11 goals. But tonight will be the acid test for the new look Cats, who are searching for their first flag since 1963.
Yes, good evening everyone, and welcome to the first big game for 1989, the Panasonic Cup Grand Final, and it should be a beauty. Magnificent conditions, a big crowd for this clash between Geelong and Melbourne. Geelong, can they make amends for last year? We'll have to wait and see, whilst for Melbourne, who knows, it could be third time lucky. As I mentioned, the crowd is enormous tonight to witness this game, but let's have a look and see how the two sides made it to the final. First up in the first round, Melbourne defeated the Sydney Swans by 16 points. They defeated Fitzroy by just 3 and had an even tougher game in the semi-final when they defeated the West Coast Eagles by 1 point. But Geelong had a far easier road. Because of their success last year, they had a bye in the first round. In the quarter-final, they hammered Essendon to the tune of 66 points. And in the semi-final, they defeated Carlton by 73 points. As far as the captains and the coaches are concerned, there are no changes. Damien Burke, as you can see there, is acting captain, but Malcolm Blight has already said that he sees no reason to change that appointment in season 1989. With me in the host set tonight, two of the former greats of the game, and it's good to have them back again, Ian Robinson and Ross Glendinning. Gentlemen, welcome, and what a buzz to be in a grand final. Yeah,
great atmosphere, isn't it?
Great to be here, Ross.
Terrific.
Yeah. Ian, tell us firstly about the Melbourne lineup.
Well, Melbourne, I think, have got a fairly solid lineup. I think the big pluses for them are Steins and O'Dwyer, the big ruckman, and Spalding playing well at centre-half forward, and I think Gary Lyon. That's going to be a very important thing for Melbourne because they have kicked low scores.
And Ross, the Cats had a long, hard trip down here tonight, didn't they, because of the traffic?
Yes, they certainly did, Sandy, but their form leading up to the game has been excellent, as you've mentioned. One less game, two big winning margins. Their forward line I like very much. Plenty of avenues to goal, and their back line is very solid, and I think Geelong looked very good tonight.
Well, whoever is making the weather decisions up there is quite obviously a football fan. A delightful night for this Panasonic Cup Grand Final. Right now, the temperature here is 19.9 degrees as we check our Holden thermometer. There is no wind, just a gentle breeze blowing across the ground, so no goal advantage. The ground conditions are firm and it's fine. The relative humidity, 69.3%.
Yes, it's a top night for football, so I certainly hope you can sit back, relax and enjoy it. Michael Roberts, incidentally, will be accompanying Dixie Marshall on the boundary line. Now, it's a big night, financially, as well as the prestige, because the winner can walk away with a total of around $95,000. All up, we've got $312,000 that has been split up by Panasonic in this particular competition. We're set for a great game of football. We'll take a break. Both sides are out on the ground, and we'll be back with the action shortly. Of screen as we go to our commentators for the first quarter, Peter McKenna, Bernie Quinlan and Drew Morford.
Thank you, Sandy, and the atmosphere great. And there's a fight on here before the game's even got underway. It's outside the centre square, Ablett involved. Well, I think that demonstrates how keen both these teams are to win a grand final. After Melbourne lost the day grand final last year by 96 points, you know, if Geelong win tonight, it'll be their first flag of any kind since 1963. So Malcolm Blight, in only his third game at the club, has a chance to win the club's first premiership for 26 years. And look at Ablett there with Brett Bailey.
Ryan Wilson having plenty to say, but I think that'll spur Gary Ablett on.
Yes, I think Gary Ablett has been showing great form on that half-back line, and he's showing that he wants to play very closely here tonight.
Ian Clayton, who's in charge of the game with Peter Carey, about to get things underway. A delayed start because of the a bit of a dust-up before the start. Burke wins the first tap, goes defensively, Off the ground by Steins, gained some ground. Spalding comes back to Steins. Caught by Couch, off the ground by McCrabb. Well picked up by Bairstow. High over the centre of the ground. Comes to the front. No time for players here. Off the ground by Stoneham. Away to Russell. Geelong first into attack. Up towards half forward. Knocked away by Hughes. It comes to the back to Cameron. He loses it in the tackle. Oh, great stuff. Eyeshaw. Didn't he crash in through there? Scott from 50 metres. Pops it up high. The whistle's gone. Could be a Geelong three right in front here.
I think it was down the ground.
Down the ground. Oh, that was a bit late. One.
So it's a...
Yep, free kick.
Free kick to Billy Brown.
That's it.
Well, Brown was paid, right
down,
in front.
Paid down the ground. Free kick after he kicked it to Geelong player Scott.
Well, you can't afford that. Particularly early in the night grand final.
There's a kick from Scott and much too late, Rodney Grinter.
Stupid play.
So Brownless right in front. A man on the mark about 25 metres from goal. Yes.
Well, that's a great start there by Billy Brownless. He's a magnificent kick for goal. He has shown good form through the night series. Hasn't kicked a real bag of goals yet, but he has really contested well. Let's have a look at this again. Here's Scott with the kick. And Grinter, he had plenty of time to stop. And, of course, Billy Brownless ending up with the kick, and you couldn't give it to a more dangerous player on the forward line.
And that back there, Billy Brownless and Danny Hughes were into each other too. So there's plenty of feeling out there as we see the bounce of the ball again. Damien Burke against Jimmy Steins, both in great form. Oshold, a quick kick towards half wood. Good use of the body then was from Lyon. It's across the half-back line. Boss tries to get away with it. Oh, tapped away. It comes as a quick kick towards the goals. And just wide and, in fact, over the line and out of bounds. That was by Gary Lyon. Talented player. There's Darren Bennett on screen, former West Coast Eagles man. And big things expected of him at full forward for Melbourne this year after that. Of course, he's had that knee operation. Here's Brian Wilson picking it up in the pack. A quick kick at the goals. This is close to goal.
And it's good stuff from Brian Wilson. He copped a nasty knock in that last night game when they played against the West Coast Eagles. And I think Alan Johnson said he had something like 30 stitches in his mouth after that game. Here it is again. Wilson behind the pack. A good knockout and an excellent snap under pressure.
So a goal each in the first 2 minutes of play. Geelong's from a free kick, relayed up the ground, and Wilson's from that snap. Bounce by umpire Clayton. Burke over the top, palming down. Russell charging at the ball, hooking it to half forward. Stoneham. Good mark. Outside 50.
Right there.
No, shocking kick, about 20 metres short, but it's all right for Brownless, who led obliquely across the ground and has taken the mark about 20 metres out.
Yes, a little too much latitude given there by Danny Hughes.
So Billy Brownless lining up for his second. Good looking kick. He's done it again. Just offline that time.
Well, Billy started clapping, whether he's trying to con the goal up or I don't know what, Bernie.
I'm sure that's been tried before, Peter.
Well, Danny Hughes' big weakness is he's slow off the mark, and that was emphasised then when Brownless was able to get away from him. And here's Brian Wilson, who kicked a goal a moment ago. I think that might have been deliberate, but the umpire giving him the benefit of the doubt. It's at half forward for Geelong. And I think we're in for a terrific contest tonight. Two pretty evenly matched sides. Geelong would be favourites. Burke and Stein. Stein's actually got that one down. Some strong work by Couch. Free kick to Healy. And the advantage was paid, and Eyeshield has put it out of bounds on the full.
Yes, so Geelong's free kick from the wing.
Thank you.
Hocking. He went for distance and missed out on getting the distance, but the mark has been taken up there.
Yes,
and pretty
yes,
fortunate to come down with it. Hamilton puts it over the top. Melbourne defence chop it off. Comes to the front to Newport. A beautiful hand pass away. Comes to Ahern. Up to half forward. Through line it goes. But he's quick to recover. Soccer's out in front of himself. He's charging after this one, waiting for the bounce. At the 50. Gets the illegal tackle and the free kick. Against Austin McCrabb.
What's the line?
From Gary Lyon, out close to the boundary line. But if he gives best kick, a chance to put Melbourne in front.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that free kick. Got the ball out in front of him, McCrabb, right into Lyon's back.
Well, he's a very dangerous player, Gary Lyon, and he's the one man that Geelong really will have to contain on that Melbourne forward line if they're to win this game. Father is a former Hawthorn player, Peter Lyon. This is Gary Lyon from 50 metres. Oh, a nice-looking drop punt. That's a beauty. Demons, they're on 2 goals straight to 1-1. 5 points the difference. Birch jumping very high at those centre bounces. Stoneham doing well at half forward. He's been in great form, Barry Stoneham. A long kick towards full forward. Brownless sets himself. Punch to the ground. Sean Denham straightens up. Centres the ball. Tries to pass it. Good play by Grinter, but there's Scott, and he's put it through. Great play by the little rover.
Yes, it's where Geelong are very strong. Have two top rovers in Scott and Denham. And they're not only good rovers around the ground, they do tremendous work up in that forward pocket. Always in the right spot. And it was Scott who did the cleaning up work there. It was a good kick from Denham too, because he just set it up in that goal square. Three Geelong players. Grinter, a lot of desperation trying to knock it through, but the Geelong with the numbers one out.
So Geelong back in front by a point. Stein's a big run at Burke, but Burke wins the tap again. All Melbourne in the middle. Stretch. Spaulding paddling on. Comes to Wilson. He's kicked one already. Clever centering kick. Lyon pulled off the ball. It was going to be a Geelong free kick. That's interesting.
Yes,
the advantage played to Andrew Bewes.
Yes, Yates was interfered with, shepherded out. Hughes. Oh, beautiful looking kick. Was meant for Scott. It was kicked away by Johnson. Now Ablett. Oh, beautiful use of the body. Clever play, Ablett. Off he goes. Oh, look at the skill of class of Ablett. Onto the left foot and a booming 60-metre kick towards half forward. Up they go. Sean White was the flyer. Damien Burke to Russell. Too slow to get rid of it. And that should be holding the ball.
Free kick!
Yes, Melbourne free kick. Be taken by Healy. Geelong 2-1, Melbourne 2 goals. Now it's coming back to Stephen Stretch. Goes towards the outer side. Steins. They've got away from Burke by about 10 metres. Kick by Steins to half forward. Lyon with McCrabb. This should be a great duel. Gary Lyon slips him again. Up to Bennett. Oh, good mark. Shrugging off Yates.
Thanks, Mark. This one.
And Bennett will be kicking for goal from 50. Gary Lyon was further out and kicked a goal.
It was a long kick, Darren Bennett, Drew.
Might be just what the Melbourne forward line needs. He's kicked at an absolute kilometre and straight.
Oh, very impressive kick there by Bennett. He's kicked that one at least 65 metres with a drop punt. And a big, strong type of player. Melbourne have been missing out at full forward for a long time, and it looks like Bennett will fill that bill there at full forward.
Well, he will.
Let's have a look at this mark. Use of the body again in front of Yates. And there he is, kicking from about the 50-metre line. Have a look where the ball finishes up. It finishes just about over the fence there behind the goals. Magnificent kick there from Bennett.
Well, he was well known for that in Western Australia for his kicking ability. They're in for a top game, 5 points of difference. Burke is very impressive at those centre bounces. So is Stoneham at half forward as he gets at the couch. Where's Brownless? He's up in front, tries to tap it over the back. Strong work by Cameron. Good play by Cameron. The tap away comes to Sean Denham, who runs towards the pocket. He's got it, the little rover. Puts it back on the left. I think he's put it out of bounds on the full. And he has. And Malcolm Blight. Looking a little bit more tense tonight than he has in past weeks. Sean White. Standing game in the last match he played. Russell.
Now,
it's a free kick.
Your ball.
Holding the man.
Your ball.
Damien Burke's kick.
Right there. Yes, right there.
Gee, Stoneham's had six possessions at centre-half forward already. He's in that direction, but Campbell comes across to take the mark. Literally straight up the ground. Geelong with the numbers. It's thumped forward to Burke, who farms it out well to Denham. To half forward. Printer with the spoil. Doesn't get it clear of the back line. Road is there. Cameron tried to keep it in, but didn't. And there'll be a throw-in.
Well, the ball is about 35 metres around from the Geelong goal. 18 points to 13. Very even contest so far. Burke has been most impressive in the ruck. And what a great series he's having. John Northey and Shane Zantuck. Steins. Burke again gets front position and taps it down. Couch was caught and that was a throw. The umpire called. And that could be 50 metres. Silly play by Dwayne Russell.
Ridiculous play because he would have heard the umpire's whistle, no doubt. And the only thing it could be is 50 metre penalty against him.
So the 50 metre penalty to come up the ground to Peter Road, former Carlton player.
Hold it, Peter, please.
And this brings him up to the wing. Melbourne 3 goals, Geelong 2 goals, 1. And we've got just under 13 minutes left in the first quarter. Lyon couldn't take the mark. Bailey grabbed. Lyon the hand pass out to Healy. Lyon turn over the top of their heads, but oh, Yates gets back there and touches it through for a behind.
And a good contest so far. Both sides really having a go at it. And fairly evenly matched, I'd say.
3 goals, 1-2-1. Mark Yates, a big job for him tonight. He's giving away a few centimetres to Darren Bennett. Bennett would be about 6'5". By the kick, I think it was meant for Boss, but it's a little bit wide. Wilson was there, kicked away by Denham. Now it's Mark Boss. Clever hand pass to Bairstow. He gets numerous possessions nearly every week. Good play by Sean White. It's taken away by his teammate in Road. Road is wide toward Bailey. Bailey against Ablett. Now, Bailey straight for the boundary line, and I think that was deliberate. That was. And the umpire's giving it against Ablett, I think. Is he?
Yes, when Bailey went to the ground, I think Ablett ran fairly close to him, may have made contact with his head or shoulder.
The umpire ruled it that he hit him high. Brett Bailey from halfback. Over the wing, Wilson. High tackle, free kick to Wilson.
Yes, Gary!
So just forward of the wing. And the Demons looking pretty impressive, up towards half forward. Eichold at the back, Lyon up there contesting. Healy just inside the line. Back to Newport. Well, grubber kick. Might come off yet, though. Oh, awkward one for Healy. He was met by Bairstow the same time as he arrived at the ball. The umpire had no option but to come in and ball it up.
Yeah, good courage there from Healy.
There's the Geelong bench. A few apprehensive players there. They'd be itching to get out there. Mark Bairstow and Gary Lyon. Well, they're two pretty fair players. And a bit of a push and shove, but a lot of tension out there at the moment. The first quarter, very, very important to try and get on top. Well done by Spaulding over the top. This is Greg Healy, straight to McCrabb. Over to Buse, went the hand pass, and Andrew Buse has gone towards the centre of the ground. Chance here for Dwayne Russell. Oh, good play by the forward pocket player. Dwayne Russell, the former Port Adelaide star, goes towards half forward. Sean White took his eyes off the ball at the split second. He's got a lot of help there by Campbell, who heads out wide to Road, and he puts it over the line.
Midway through the first quarter, Melbourne 3-1, Geelong 2-1, in a very entertaining start to the Panasonic Cup Grand Final. And plenty of people have come the long trip down the highway from Geelong area to be here tonight. Big knock by Hocking, comes back from White. Eichold, number 25. Gains a few metres and finds the boundary line. It's a long way away over there. Binoculars sometimes come in handy. And the match could be decided here in ruck contest. There's O'Dwyer, who'll come onto the ground later to help Jim Steins. Here's Steins against Burke. Burke's had his hand to most of them. Goes to Couch. Bairstow. Great setup by Geelong. Russell, a centering kick. Brownless not in the contest. Grinter played it well.
Well, the Geelong forwards, oh, that's a free kick against Grinter. I think he pushed him in the face, Bernie.
No doubt about it. Has to be a free kick.
It's a free kick to Denham. And Grinter gave us... Let's have a look at it again.
Yes, here it is. Pushed right in the face. And a free kick to Denham.
Sean Denham made sure the umpire saw it too. But there's the little rover. Will kick from about 51 metres on the left foot. It won't quite make the distance. Stoneham from behind, but it's bumped over the line and through for a behind by Sean White. So the Cats move on to 2-2. Melbourne on 3-1. Denny Hughes about to bring it back into play.
Johnson in the back pocket. Longer kick up towards the wing. Stretch holding off his opponent. Oh, beautiful play by Bailey. Finds a man lying unmarked. If he's quick, he's got somebody further afield. He goes for that play a bit high for Bennett, but he's got it. Now it's Earl Spaulding just inside 50. Well, Melbourne have had two goals from about the 50-metre line and wide out, both from the far side of the ground. See if Spaulding can do it from this grandstand side. Slightly offline.
Well, I wouldn't have backed Earl Spaulding from there. He's not a great kick.
Well, that started, that attacking move from Melbourne started because the Geelong Rover didn't pick up his man from the kicker.
Tommy must get out of the square area.
3-2 to 2-2, and as Bernie said earlier, a very even contest this so far. And Malcolm Blight, well, he's looking pretty casual. Mark Yates, a tremendous goer for Geelong. He said earlier, he gives away centimetres every week. Good mark to Steins in front of Damien Burke. Now he's got a loose man in Alan Johnson who's come down the ground. And Johnson has marked, and there's some very loose checking there by Geelong.
Well, he's left his position by about 150 metres. They're really covering ground.
Not again.
Unless he's been moved. Just looking back up the ground, Sharon is up in the back pocket.
Yes, it looks like Johnson has been moved up the ground.
Well, here he is, Alan Johnson, having a shot for goal. It's a good-looking drop punt.
Has gone right back to Melbourne's half-back line. Hasn't an opponent at the moment. Looks as though he may have nearly drifted up from the back pocket to kick that one. Steins beats Burke in the middle for once, but can't get it clear, and we'll have another ball up. Just over 8 minutes remaining in the first quarter. 4-2 to 2-2, Melbourne in front. Geelong starting favourites after their two big victories leading up to this. Back to the centre circle. Free kick in there to Couch, who can kick it a long way for a little bloke.
Paul Couch towards half foot. A bit of wrestling going on there. Too strong, Stoneham. Couldn't quite hold them up. This is Ahern. Only a youngster, John Ahern. Wide. Ablett waited for the bounce. I thought he probably could have got there to mark that, Bernie.
He seemed to just go a little bit easy on that one, didn't he, Gary Ablett?
Well, he hasn't done a lot so far, Gary, except at the start of the game. The classy Cats can kill. Well, that's yet to be proved tonight. As we see Burke doing well, gets it to Couch. Stoneham, well, shoved out of the way, but it's over the back. Hamilton, and Johnson's there again. He reads the play beautifully, Alan Johnson, Bernie.
Well, he doesn't seem to have an opponent there. He seems to be a loose man in defence, Alan Johnson.
Actually, it would appear that both pack boxers are playing the same role because Buse is up the ground, giving Geelong an extra man around the packs, and Johnson just roaming free. Burke and Steins. Burke to the front. Baldwin, straight up in the air, will have to do it again. Taken by Wilson. Quickly put the ground. That's Wilson now gathering well to Healy. Melbourne straight up the ground. Spaulding gets it back. Paddle forward for the Demons. Here's an opening. Spaulding kept on going. Approaches 50. Off the left boot. Oh, beautiful kick, but just a bit too long for Lyon. Gets closed by Christensen, who's on the ground. McCrabb's there, and with the help of Christensen, breaks away. And a beautiful pass to halfback flank. Playing on Denham. Didn't see the opponent there.
Hughes. Over it goes towards his teammate. Oh, blocking. They're under a bit of pressure. Back to Denham, an ordinary kick by Denham, straight to Steins. And Steins, a beautifully directed kick, he's found a man too, and this is Alan Johnson again, who's in everything. The short pass is on Bennett, might have topped one in the back. Umpire didn't think so. Yates recovers and gets away, kicks long right up towards the centre of the ground. It's fisted away. Ablett, oh, bit of an elbow there. The umpire on the blind side, Gary Ablett, went in very, very hard. Onto the left foot, he hooks it back, centre of the ground again. Up went Damien Burke. Bairstow is in there. Burke doing well. Well done to Denham. Now it's back to Bairstow. Bairstow long, he'll be looking for Brownless. Over the back is Cameron. A chance for Little Scott, who is holding on to Sharon. Umpire saw it, and Dean Sharon will get the kick.
Oh, what a pity Scott messed that up with an illegal tackle there, because Geelong didn't step on a blade of grass that was outside the centre corridor, straight up the ground. Sharon goes very wide for Newport. Oh, he poked it a bit too far for Stretch. And Stretch will get the free kick. That was a poor tackle by Christensen.
Yes, I agree. And he really had the front running for that ball. Stephen Stretch towards half forward. 2-on-2 here. Oh, Boss couldn't quite hold onto it. There's a chance for Melbourne again. That's Newport towards half forward. Austin McCrabb has been in the surprise packet in recent weeks. Tries to tap it back into play.
Thanks, Ross.
But unfortunately for him, the ball went over the line, or maybe fortunately. Here's the Melbourne bench, 4-2 to 2-2. It's only two goals the difference, a very even contest. Again, Little Denham was in after it. He's lost it to Gary Lyon, who's looking very, very dangerous up forward. Clever kick back towards the pocket. Greg Healy's there. He's good enough to go and get it again after a touch of the fumbles. Ahern, he couldn't control it. Oh, Healy caught one in the back. And umpire Ian Clayton will come in and bounce it right near the boundary line at the 50-metre mark. Melbourne's forward zone. There's a couple of youngsters enjoying a hot pie.
I think those two back pockets are floating around the ground. In fact, now Buse and Johnson are opponents, and they are back pockets. Don't know whether we've ever seen that before. Bairstow played it well. And Cats there in number. Baldwin. Christensen, clever mark. Drives it straight up the ground towards centre half forward. Knocked away by Campbell from Stoneham. Cats first there again. Russell. He's out. Ball's in. Russell will get the free. He was held when not in possession, even though he was outside the field of play.
He's really picked up his pace this year, Dwayne Russell, Bernie.
He has improved a lot, hasn't he, Russell? He struggled a bit last year.
Well, he was a state player for South Australia as he brings it. Looking for Brownless again. Over the back. Here's a chance for Scott. He's hooked it back. He's hit the post. Well, that's bad luck. It was beautiful roving, that, by Robert Scott.
Yes, we see it so often with the Geelong Rovers. There's Sharon picking up Robert Scott.
So Melbourne getting a bit of a break. 4-2 to 2 goals, 3. Russell front of the pack. Pulled off his mark. Stretch went through without the ball. Baldwin number 44, caught by Stretch. Play on. There's Buse. Up at about half forward. To Johnson. His kick, no distance. Comes away to Grinter. And he just puts it out in front of teammates. A sprint for the ball. Lyon and McCrabb. Sensational duel, this. Oh, and that's beautifully picked up by Ahern. Oh, well played by the man who hasn't played a league game yet. Goes to Grinter. Off the left boot for Healy. Ablett over the top of him. Should have taken the mark. It comes back to Ablett. Perhaps a bit fortunate.
Oh, magnificent skills, though, by Ablett. Up the centre corridor again. And let's see if he goes for one of his booming kicks. No, a bad hand pass by Ablett. Oh, they're good enough to get away with it, though, because Boss was waiting. A good tackle by Geelong. There's Brownless, the flyer. Tapped away by Sean White. Stoneham couldn't control the ball. Here's Peter Rode with a hand pass to Eichold. Good play this by Melbourne as Bailey comes through the centre and kicks long. They've got a loose man there. A chance for the Demons because this is Healy. He's gone short. Mark Gates has got three players to beat. And he did well too. Beautiful defensive play by Geelong as crashing it away was Hocking towards the boundary line. Mark Boss is there to kick it further around. And they got out of jail there. Oh, they're not out of it yet though. Because there's Newport hooking it back towards Bennett. He couldn't take the mark. It's a loose ball again. Couch. Further afield, Bairstow. Oh, geez, highly skilled this player as he brings it to centre wing.
Burke's there. Met by Campbell. Campbell takes the ball away. And a beautiful pass to Ahern. 60 metres from goal, just inside the boundary line. Ahern goes long and high. 15 metres short. Bennett out number 2-1. Comes to the front. Wilson tried to rove it. Out of defence by Boss. Great control by Steins. Puts the hand pass away. Newport goes for goal. Across the face. Eichel. Yes.
Hold it, son. Hold it.
He's on a very tight angle here, Simon Eichel. What great skills there from big Jim Steins.
Couple more.
He bursts through the centre there. Magnificent hand pass. And have a look at this angle that Simon Eichel has to kick this goal from.
Should kick on the left, Bernie.
Eichel improves his angle a bit. Tries to banana it back. Not far enough. And behind.
Well, I'm a great believer. When you're on those boundaries, I think you'd agree, Bernie, and run out on that left foot and try and hook him back in. You're a big chance.
Oh, the banana kick, which he tried, but he just couldn't get it around quickly enough.
And there's Mark Yates. They'd be breathing a sigh of relief. They wouldn't have got to go three goals down. That's a bad kick, though, by Yates. Straight to Spalding. Play on, the umpire's call, as you heard, and lovely-looking kick by Spalding. Sets it up for Bennett again. Nearly a mark. No, it's Bennett now picking it up, but he's missed. It was Lyon who almost took the mark. And Bennett did the roving and nearly put it through, and Malcolm Blight not impressed.
They're looking good, Melbourne, tonight. They're really tackling hard, doing the things that Geelong did against Carlton.
Eight shots to five. It's as though somebody might have sampled the football. Policeman going over the fence to go and retrieve it. Now, is he going to get the ball or get the culprit? Might be under somebody's jumper.
Well, they're just having a few stern words, I think.
Oh, they're throwing it back in.
All right, so the ball back in play. With a kick straight up the centre of the ground. Abbott crashes into the pack. Steins cleverly taps through to Healy. Just about to get rid of it. Ball by Hocking. And Hocking forces the ball up. Well played.
Well, I think that was a Gaelic hand pass there from Jim Steins.
A bit of a throw.
He slapped the ball. But it was clever, nevertheless, by Steins. John Northey's done a marvellous job at Melbourne since he took over as coach. It's at the 50-metre line for Melbourne. Spalding cleverly. Oh, Healy over the top. This Johnson into an open goal. And he's missed. It was Alan Johnson. And is he covering some territory? But 4-5, they should be further in front. 4-5 plays 2-3.
Yes, they've had a lot of chances. That wasn't a hard shot at goal from Alan Johnson.
So time running out. Just 18 seconds left in the first quarter. Comes to Ahern. Running out of room. Have they got time to get another one? Buse is in there. I think the Cats have foiled them here. The ball goes out of bounds and we'll have a throw in, and this will be the last piece of action in the first quarter. A quarter in which Melbourne have surprised Geelong, who started hot favourites.
Right at it!
And that's quarter time here in the grand final. Melbourne 4-5-29, leading Geelong 2-3-15.
Final, and Melbourne leads 4-5-29, Geelong 2-3-15, but a truly great first quarter by all players concerned, one of which tonight will be named the Panasonic Player of the Match, and he gets a great prize.
The Panasonic Cup Player of the Match will receive from Panasonic this compact design video cassette recorder with exciting super fine slow and super still effects which deliver ultra high picture quality. Auto operations make everything so easy you hardly need to think about it.
Ross Glendinning is with me at the moment as the players prepare for the second quarter, and we couldn't have asked for anything more, Ross, in that first term.
No, what a great opening, Sandy, and both sides really throwing themselves into this game, and the pace of the game has been, I think, quite marvellous really for this time of year.
Tackling by both sides.
Both forward lines are putting great pressure on their respective backmen, and a couple of duels, McCrabb and Lyon going very well, Damien Christensen and Tony Campbell, both centre forwards respectively, are finding kicks hard to come by, but there's some great tussles there, and Melbourne could have had a couple of extra goals there, Sandy.
All right, let's go down to the boundary line now. Dixie Marshall and Michael Roberts.
Sandy, despite the score, it's still a very unanimated Malcolm Blight. He says his players are just too loose. They're not backing themselves. They've got to make some decisions and go for it. The crumbing must improve. Michael.
John Northey spoke in his usual quiet manner. He wants the endeavour and tackling kept up, and those players given specific jobs must concentrate in the second quarter.
Well, the margin is just 14 points. Now for the second quarter, here's Ian Robertson, Don Scott and Peter Landy.
Thank you, Sandy. Umpire Peter Carey to bounce the ball. 14 points the difference in favour of the Demons. Damien Burke, one of the Cats' best in the opening term. gets this one again away from Steins, but of course O'Dwyer is waiting in the wings. Couch affects the hand pass. It was partly smothered. Down goes Bairstow. He got one a little bit too high. Umpire calling it play on. Eichold's kick is short. Hocking. Now it comes to Boss. He's up towards half forward. Campbell. Now to Stoneman, who started off well. Hooks it across his body up towards full forward. Almost a high tackle. The umpire said nothing for it. It's a scramble and a pack developing inside the 50-metre mark. Don.
And Alan Johnson's gone back into the back pocket and Dean Charon into the forward pocket for Melbourne.
The play about 35 metres out from the Geelong goal. And a tremendously entertaining first quarter. Steins pumped up. Punch away. Healy. At half back for Melbourne. White gives Campbell a run at the ball. Good tackle by Stoneham. And the ball goes over the top for a boundary throw in about 40 metres from the Geelong goal.
Stoneham works very, very hard as a centre half forward.
Yes, Campbell got the big job there of containing Barry Stoneham at centre half forward. Burke tapped on by Charon out the back. Ahern, a very clever player. Hand passes to Rode and the Demons are on the run. Rode's kick wide. Not quite wide enough there to give Spaulding a bit of a run at it. His tap at the back, nearly tidied up by Boss, but here comes that clever player line. He's well tackled by McCrabb. He gets the kick away. Hocking under pressure. Hand passes wide. Couch is caught by Eichold. Now the play. Lyon on centre wing. Gets the handball out wide to Ahern. Ahern can't control it, and it goes over, and we'll have a boundary throw in. The play now on Melbourne's half forward line.
Ahern's a surprise packet. He's doing well, Ian. Temper's becoming frayed again. Understandable under the pressure conditions out there. Pretty crowded sort of a throw-in. About 20 players around this. Couch was the high flyer from the back. It comes to Scott, who hit the post in the first quarter with a beautiful snapshot. Russell playing a lot better than he did in the semi-final. He was taken from the ground then by Malcolm Blake, but he's done well so far this evening. Long kick. And all Geelong players developing that as a forte. Socket away by Hamilton. Johnson, who covered more ground than Burke and Wills in the opening term, capped it off with a good goal. Now it comes to Cameron, gets clear, onto the left. Burke might slew out of bounds. It does. Inside 50, we'll see a throw in close to Geelong's forward pocket.
Great desperate play there by Sean White to force that pressure kick from Cameron.
29 plays 15, so no addition to the score. So far in the second term, huge crowd here at the park. Monumental traffic jams. Between 8 and 8.30. Rode. That's got to be a free kick to Alan Johnson. Started the season off in fine fettle. And as he told us on Sports World last Sunday, looking forward to a good season. Wilson. A little bit of fire at him before the game even got underway tonight. Bailey off the ground. And Melbourne have been doing that well tonight. Little open spaces. Ablett goes for the boundary line. Frank Arrott would have been happy with that one. It'll be a throw-in.
He had a quick look over his shoulder at the umpire too, Peter, then maybe thinking that he could have been penalised.
I think the fingers were crossed.
So fine line, isn't there?
Well, there certainly is, because the umpires, they jump on it sometimes and other times let it go. So we've got a boundary throw-in just outside 50 metres in Melbourne's forward line. Punch away by the Geelong defence. The ball comes back towards centre wing. Eichold overruns it. A little bit sloppy. Had time to recover. His left foot kick is good. Covers 50 metres to the front of the goals. Now the race is on. Lyons kick off the ground. Goes towards the goal. It's rushed through for a behind by Hocking. So the first score of the second quarter is a rush behind to Melbourne. 4-6 plays 2-3. And there's big Steve O'Dwyer. He'd be keen to get into the action, I would think. Kicking in being done by Mark Yates. He comes to the member's side. It's a short kick, but it's a great mark taken by Scott. He was behind. Now he plays on. His recovery is good from the fallen position. Kick towards centre-half forward. And there is the centre-half forward for Geelong, Stoneham taking the mark. He's closer to the centre of the field. His kick's a wobbly one. Now it goes towards the half-forward line. Coming through Brownless. Gathers well. Handball over the top wide. Christensen. Scott falls over at the crucial stage. Tidied up by Rode. Melbourne.
Downfield.
Kicked by Rode. He was flattened as he kicked it. And the ball, as Peter Landy has just explained, will go forward to centre wing. And the free kick will be taken by Spaulding.
Plenty of yelling down there by players and umpires alike. Sporting it is with the free kick, a relayed kick downfield from left centre wing. Sporting centres the ball. Adlett, the flyer at the back, should have tried to punch. I think he tried to outmark in the back, and Bennett's got the mark. Is that a correct summing up, Don? Did he try to mark that, or was he just in bad position?
Well, when you're in that position, as Ablett was then, you should always punch. And McCrabb was also in that position to punch. But Bennett, too hard to mark over.
There's a long kick going for goal number two. Darren Bennett on 50. He'll get the distance. And the accuracy, it's a goal. I think in his second outing here, Don, he came out with the wrong stops. Didn't he have moulded soles on that night? He was taken from the ground.
He was taken from the ground, Peter, but he played an excellent first game.
Yes, he got four goals and he's got two tonight. And Melbourne doing it well so far. I'll be hoping they can keep this up. Ball booted out towards the centre wing position. And Melbourne again getting first at the ball at Steins. Well shepherded by Ahern, who's done well tonight. That might be a free kick to Melbourne.
It's an interesting battle between both Burke and Stein. Stein's the mobility and Burke's got more ruck craft.
Ahern nearly had a rush of blood because he thought about going for the hand pass. Luckily he didn't. Bennett tried to hoof it off the ground. Trying to get clear as Andy Bewes. Not successful. The ball booted out towards Couch. Geelong defending desperately at the moment. Melbourne on top. Desperation. Rode the spoil. Free kick to Russell. And Russell will take the free kick at right halfback.
I dare say Bewes was a bit lucky up in that back pocket, Don. That free kick would have been given further up the field. Russell on defensive side of centre wing. His kick comes up towards the half forward line for Geelong. Breaking clear is Hamilton. Gets the hand pass out to Couch. Couch's high kick. Centre half forward. Good punch away by Hughes. Roving well is Scott. Turns, straightens, goes for goal. It's close. Right. Just
free kick.
Is a free kick being paid? It's going to Melbourne. And Sean White will be the recipient.
It's Wade! It's Wade! Over here, David!
Very clearly, umpire Clayton asking the player which way he's going to kick. Elects to come to members' side. Marking over the top of the pack is the acting captain for Geelong, Damien Burke.
Better judgment on that occasion by the big fellow.
He'll have to kick the ball about 50 metres if he's going to score. Takes two steps, not enough. Hooks it across the face. Punch away. Melbourne defence under enormous pressure. Experience comes out on top. Johnson runs through the back pocket and kicks it out to the winger. Magnificent kick and fine stretch. Stretch at half back. Melbourne doing well with their use of the football. Stretches kick. Goes over centre wing. Towards half forward. In front Spalding. Tidying up Bailey. Bailey's quick kick to half forward. Goes over the top of both players. Coming out in front is Yates. Yates' kick into the centre has been marked by Chiron.
Chiron, centre field. Goes for the hand pass. Steins. Makes amends for the fumble. Centering kick. And Ablett's there on his own.
It's as though he picked him out, doesn't it?
Looked that way. Ablett can kick the ball long and does so. Straight down the ground. Steins up high. Might have infringed. Stone will get the free kick short of half forward. One of Geelong's best players so far. Probably we put Scott and Burke in that category as well. Stoneham, direct again. The target. Brown was a great grab.
The Melbourne backs, it's quite interesting watching the Melbourne backs. They're great moppers up. They don't initiate play. They don't attack the ball. They wait for a mistake and then they take it away and start and create and run the ball. But the few of these Melbourne fellows have got to get in front and start and initiate some play.
Now, one of the longest kicks in the game. In fact, we've got Bennett at the other end and Brownless at this end. Two fine exponents have had a kick of football. Great kick, Billy Brown. 45 remaining in the term, 5-6 to 3-3. It's ineffectual ruck work at the centre there. Healy's kick smothered. Couch runs into trouble. And I think we'll go through it all again. Another bounce just wide of the centre circle.
Now it is now Johnson moving from the back pocket up into the forward line and Bewes following him.
Last goal, very important for Geelong.
They needed that one, didn't they?
Bounce in the centre. Burke, Denham. Denham's quick kick towards the half-forward flank. Stoneham chipping in Wilson. Kick off the ground. Look at Geelong outnumbering. Hocking can't break clear. Tackling is magnificent. Christensen to Russell. Russell's left-foot kick. Grinter over the top. Should have stayed on the ground. Brownless now. Gives Hamilton. Grinter's opponent the chance. And he misses.
see there, as soon as Shane Hamilton kicked the ball, the hands went to the head in despair.
He kicked 5 in the game at the SCG last year. He was on the spot there, not tonight.
Bad miss. Hughes comes to the member's side, gives his teammate a chance to run at it, Newport, and he gathers a little bit of good fortune with the bounce. He's kicking short, great punch away by Ablett, and it goes over for a boundary throw-in.
The scoreboard not a true indication of this game. Geelong should be right up there with them, just not capitalising on the scoreboard, and Melbourne not safe.
5-6 plays, 3-4.
Right at it!
14 points, the Demons' advantage on centre wing. Eichold can't break clear. Boss, the Geelong player, and umpire Clayton will come in and bounce. So just a little bit of quiet play there after the last goal, kicked by Brownless. Bumping Boss. Goes after it again. Bailey, tap onto Ahern. Ahern gathers 25 metres for his side, but it goes over for another boundary throw-in.
Good prospect, John Ahern, 6'4" on a wing.
Big boy, very agile. John Northey looking on. Spalding, Ahern is there again, but he can't gather the football. No one can control it. Newport on the bottom of it. And the umpire will come in and bounce again. He's getting a little frustrated, encouraging the players to perhaps try and move the ball on as much as possible.
To bounce left half forward. Outside the 50-metre mark in Melbourne's attacking zone. Ball thrown over the head of Newport. And free kick going the Demons' way. Greg Healy looking for it. So too, Johnson has his hand in the air.
It's a severe penalty, Peter, isn't it? The player, the Geelong player, perhaps not quite recording that it was going to be a free kick. He kicks the ball, 50-metre penalty, and now here's a big chance for Melbourne to kick a goal.
Greg Healy will take it.
There it is there.
Well, a 50-metre penalty is actually a 100-metre penalty, isn't it? It's 50 metres plus the kick.
Exactly.
What on a call?
We won't worry about the second part of it here because he'll get the distance. He doesn't get the accuracy. A bad miss by Greg Healy. One behind. The goal would have been more than useful halfway through the second quarter. So 5-7 to 3-4. Good to see Healy back after popping another head injury. Without the helmet though, Ablett.
He may play that huddle, Geelong. Ablett's the one with a great speed to get out and create.
Denham fumbles. Makes amends for it though. Eichold sets it up with a hand pass. Wilson likewise fumbles, but he's got the speed. Over the head of Christensen. When it comes to Eichold again, they're going by the cape. Johnson always does something with the ball. What can he do here? Gets around Yates. Finds Healy.
Good play. Kick. He saw that player there.
Johnson getting away from Hughes on that occasion. Johnson starting in the back pocket, drifting down the ground and taking his man with him. Hughes a little loose.
Greg Healy's been pumping a bit of iron during the summer. He seems to have put on a few pounds around the chest, doesn't he?
He's been hitting the speed ball vigorously.
Has he got? On the boundary, Healy will probably kick this one. It's the more difficult of the two shots he had. No, out of bounds this time, touched off the hands. So, a chance for the Demons to improve their score.
Look at it now!
Nick one, Pearl one. Another free kick. This time going Geelong's way. I think it might be taken by Boss, is it? Yes, it is. Mark Boss to take the free kick just up from the back pocket.
Plays on and goes across goal. Kicks well with the left foot, covers 55 metres towards centre wing. Punch away, the gatherers by Christensen. His quick kick towards centre half forward, good punch away by Campbell. Coming through strongly, Hocking, great smother Campbell. Grinter, hand pass wide to Stretch. Stretch around the corner, goes towards half forward. And there's a mark to Melbourne. A good one too, taken by their captain, Greg Healy. And he'll put the Melbourne side within goal scoring distance. Oh, a little unfortunate there. Slipping over, Buse tidies up and kicks Geelong straight towards their goal, towards centre half forward. But Melbourne have the numbers at ground level. Grinter, little short chip pass is okay, and Rowe takes the mark. That could be 50, no it's not. Umpire Carey officiating, had a good look at it, and Rowe will go back and take the kick. He kicks it wide towards centre wing, at the back, good punch away, stretches there, roving it well.
takes his 10 metres and thumps it towards full forward, coming out in front. Good punch away by the Geelong defence. In the centre, Buse. Buse's hand pass has put Scott under pressure, taking it back now. Here's a chance for Baldwin. Baldwin's kick up towards full forward, punch away by Hughes. Denham's quick kick is good. Wright, desperate, throws himself on the football, but he doesn't knock it far enough away, and Cameron will take the free kick in the forward pocket for Geelong.
That wasn't a good punch away then by Sean White. He just didn't quite get onto the ball. Should have, well, I suppose in that situation you should have made contact, but he just slipped at the crucial time and just couldn't get the arm over there.
Crude tackle there by Danny Hughes, I would have thought too, Don.
We watch there now. White just missing the ball. And good play by Cameron to actually let the ball go. He knew Hughes was coming and he played for it. Well, it was a good play.
Actually, I'll retract that because Hughes' tackle was well within shoulders and knees. Cameron's kick across the face, marking contest. Ball at the front of the pack, Ahern. Stoneham, Brownless, caught with a football, gets it out. Quick kick right on the line. He's punched through for a rush behind a Geelong. The kicker was Baldwin.
Ahern and Stoneham more intent on having a box on there than watching the ball. Could have almost proved costly. Ball out wide. Wilson and Buse. Cameron gets the front running. Two on one in favour of the Cats. Beautifully done to Buse. Hooked across his body. In front, Danny Hughes. Brownless. Snapshot. Good. It's a goal. It's his third. Or is it a point?
Hit the post.
I think there's a free kick. Yeah, I thought the Brownless actually pushed Hughes off the ball. Hughes going for the ball, got in front on that occasion and pushed the ball away.
Geelong fans voicing their disapproval, as you can no doubt hear. Could have almost been another one against McCrabb there for cattening into the back of his opponent. Ball socketed away by Eichold. Healy and Bairstow. It's out of bounds. Beating both of them. Right half forward flank for Melbourne. 5 minutes and a bit left in the first half. Malcolm Blight obviously a little bit more concerned tonight than he would have been in the previous two outings. Boss and Spaulding. Burke having a rest.
High
tackle. Going Melbourne's way. Greg Healy picking up a lot of kicks.
Hold it.
Umpire Peter Carey putting a whistle on play. Healy will kick it again.
I thought that was a bit tiggy touch with Don.
A lot of these decisions are here.
Seven kicks and three hand passes.
But he had to kick over his mark, then the umpire said.
Hey, Sugar!
Healy at right half forward. And out leads Bennett. Not too where near the ball. Out to Bailey. Plenty of red and blue jumpers down there. Eichold, left foot snap. Is close and he's threaded.
Demon fans, Steve O'Dwyer. And does he want to get into it or what? Bounce back in the centre. Stones comes back towards centre half back from the Burke punch. Campbell, kick towards half forward. Marking contest. Lyon, good defensive work. Ablett out in front. Will have too much pace for Bailey. Good play by Stretch, anticipating it and intercepted to see it over the line for a boundary throw in on centre wing.
Ahern off for Melbourne. O'Dwyer on. It'll be interesting to see who goes onto the wing. Looks like Earl Spaulding.
O'Dwyer straight into it. Burke in front. Hocking. Good play. Has a bit of a look around and takes a couple of bounces, running in towards the centre of the field. Now he kicks it very direct towards the full forward position. Great punch away. Good tidying up by Denham. A little bit too hard for Russell. Sharon and White combine for Melbourne. And White kicks it just a little short underground pass. And it goes over the line for a boundary throw-in.
Steins at centre half forward for Melbourne. O'Dwyer now in the ruck.
Could be a good battle, this one.
Look at the ball!
Two redheads.
Well, Burke and O'Dwyer. The day after St. Patrick's Day, what more could you want? Cameron, or was that Hocking? Cameron. Johnson, who's played a great game so far. Play on, it's out of bounds. They can't do that. 20 points the difference in favour of Melbourne. Demon veteran Evan Johnson in top form.
Same again, straight at it!
Burke on the chest. Rode goes for the boundary line. And the boundary umpire will again throw it in. A little bit further around from the goals. 3.5 minutes remaining in the second term.
Look at it now.
Dwyer and Burke. It's a wrestle. And Dwyer won that one. Although not very decisively. Couch almost into the back of his opponent. The umpire says nothing for it. Ball picked up by Russell. Stoneham left it for Brownless, and then Stoneham picks up the crumbs beautifully to shoot for goal and puts it through for a badly needed one.
Well, he is a worker, Stoneham. It's good to see him get rewarded on the scoreboard. Barry Stoneham, the centre half forward for Geelong. A little critical, as I was earlier in the first, earlier in this quarter. The Melbourne players, especially on that back line, are being led to the ball. They should start initiating. Danny Hughes behind on that occasion. Although Campbell was in front, he went for the mark. Had Hughes had been there in front, he could have at least punched the ball away and got the ball moving again. But Stoneham, good work.
Yes, a very good player is Stoneham, much improved over the last couple of seasons. And a badly needed goal close to half-time for Geelong. O'Dwyer gets a tap out. Spalding can't take it away. Now Melbourne get it clear through Newport. He's kicked towards centre-half forward. It comes to the back. Lyon out of position. Interferes with McCrabb. And McCrabb takes the free kick. The umpire calls play on. The kick now goes towards Geelong's centre-half forward position. The punch away. Chiron.
Well
O'Dwyer
done.
Now's into it. Hand pass to Steins. Look at the two big ruckmen combined. Ball comes wide to Wilson. Wilson goes for goal with a long drop punt. Bennett's taken the mark anyway. He was being held onto. And Bennett has the football in the goal square. Should kick a goal.
He's the player Melbourne have been waiting for. See, it lets Lyon out, and then Lyon's a dangerous player. Lyon had the responsibility last year, and the last couple of years of being the only 6'2", 6'3" player down there, and he's just not big enough to do what Bennett is able to do there. Hold his ground and take him out.
Would have been a free kick anyway, Don, wouldn't it?
Four more, please.
Well, I did get the impression that the whistle was blown, so
yeah.
The free kick or the mark, Bennett will kick a goal. It's there.
Demons increased their lead to 20 points. They led by 14 at the first change. Of course, if Burke gets tired, Melbourne, oh, that might be against Steve O'Dwyer, and Burke is down.
That's one thing when you're a ruckman, you've got to expect a bad bounce. You're caught underneath. The guy's committed.
Not the greatest of kicks on the side. And an easy mark taken by Rowe. Not Spalding. Now the whistle is gone. He has to bring it back anyway. Burke, incidentally, still in the hands of the trainers. I don't know whether we have that on replay, but I think he might have some sore ribs.
Tell you what, I'd like to see the next time they come close together, Burke and O'Dwyer, after what O'Dwyer did.
Reminds you of the clash you had with Gary Dempsey one day, Don. At the centre bounce. It was a good one. Oh, Albert's what a mark! Oh! I think we'll see that on Sports World tomorrow.
Spring Hill Jack effort. He is fantastic, isn't he?
Burke might be coming off. He's looking particularly sore at the moment. Chiron boots the ball out of the pack. The recipient is Bailey. 15-metre hand pass. Grinter. Steins on his own. Left half forward. Ross a little bit late on the scene. Fine mark, Healy.
What a great kick from Steins.
He's got the hardest job, like playing in the ruck and then going to centre-half forward. I hated it because you come looking for a spell. You've got to work at centre-half forward.
Work off the ground. And that kick off target. One behind. Melbourne lead by 21 points. The Geelong head trainer with his assistants taking Burke from the ground. I don't think there's any broken bones, but he does look a little bit tender around the midsection. We'll get a report shortly. 50 to 29.
Yates kicks it in. Geelong now undermanned in the height stakes. They come away from half back through Hocking. He has a really good look before he delivers the football. Left foot up towards centre half forward. Comes to the back. Good play by Denham. A bad bounce there for Russell.
Through the ball!
And no more explanation necessary there. Umpire Clayton awarding the free kick at centre half back to Melbourne. And it will be taken
please
by Rowe.
Burke going to the rooms.
Thanks, yes. No, one. Back to one.
Hearing the umpires is a terrific innovation. I feel that they certainly give everyone the exact idea of what's happening with the free kicks. Rhodes kick towards centre-half forward for Melbourne. Good punch away. Now good punch by O'Dwyer out wide. Steins. Buse gathers. Handball wide is not really effective. Steins grabs it.
off to Wilson. Wilson inside 50. Goes bang. He's put it through. Great goal.
See, that was a terrific passage of play. O'Dwyer, and as Burke goes up the race there, the two big fellows, his opposite numbers, O'Dwyer and Steins combining in that passage of play. O'Dwyer first, now Wircher here, he got it across. And what a tackle there on Bewes by Steins, and the big fella follows up Wilson. And a good kick from 50 metres out. Melbourne starting to capitalise on that scoreboard now, 56-29.
That kick by Wilson. He's kicked his second, and there's only seconds left in this quarter. O'Dwyer goes straight at Schultz. Schultz gets the ball out. Ablett. Here come the Demons again in numbers. Bailey is kicked to half forward, and the siren sounds to end the second term when Melbourne, leading by 27 points, 8-8-56, lead Geelong 4-5-29.
Well, Steve O'Dwyer struck a great blow for Melbourne when he puts the acting captain for the Cats out of business. We don't know how bad the injury is, but Donnett gets us to pose the question, going into a game such as this with only one key big man, it's come unstuck, hasn't it?
Well, it has, Peter, but a lot of teams do it nowadays. It's just fortunate Melbourne have got two players that combine together and one can take the pressure off one another. If one does get hurt, the other one's there. But Geelong in a little bit of trouble. They've got Schultz now, he's a big fellow, but not quite as big as Burke.
Okay, so at half-time, after leading by 14 points at the first change, the Demons have increased that to a lead of 27 points. They kick 4-3 to 2-2 in that term. It's 56-29 at half-time.
Panasonic Cup and the Demons lead by 27 points. 8 goals, 8, 56 to Geelong. 4 goals, 5, 29. As I said, the margin is 27 points, but we've still got a great half of football to come. Let's take this 7 Nightly News Update.
Good evening, Kate Dunstan in the 7 Newsroom. Flamboyant businessman Nick Collum's filly Kortzer today won the Golden Slipper at Rose Hill in Sydney. She's netted Collum more than $1 million in stake money and follows Kortzer's Blue Diamond win a fortnight ago. And don't forget, daylight saving ends tonight. The clocks go back an hour at 2 a.m. so we all get an extra hour's sleep. That's all from the newsroom. Good night.
7 Nightly News, 6:30.
Busy today, Scott Palmer, and I believe, Scott, in fact, it should be Dr. Palmer, should it not, as we start proceedings?
What a day we've had today, Sandy. Two players, Michael Mitchell of Richmond, Ian Herman of Carlton, in hospital tonight, suffering concussion.
Scotty, and what about reports from today?
Three reports, Sandy. Philip Egan for abusive language after going to the aid of Michael Mitchell. Paul Spargo for shepherding with a forearm. And Michael Thompson for striking an opponent. And of course, two North players, Mark Lyle and Warren Carey, they're in hospital tonight with the dislocated shoulders and will miss 10 weeks.
Gee, that's bad luck for the Roos. What about today's game, Scotty?
The Brisbane Bears came from behind today to beat Essendon at Carrara, 13-13 to 11-17, after the Bombers had secretly flown in Michael Long from Darwin, and he played well.
Scotty, last week you were wearing some ridiculous little hat, and I believe you've got something else again for us tonight. I can't believe it, but what is it?
It's North's birthday, 120th birthday tomorrow, and John Kennedy's going to wear one of these out at the ground. But he hasn't got much to celebrate tonight, Sandy.
And in closing, what are we going to do?
Well, we're going to keep punching, mate.
We certainly shall. Thank you, Scotty Palmer. So there it is. He'll be back with, of course, more news as the football season unfolds in season 1989. I wonder what they've got to say in the rooms, particularly Geelong. They trailed by 27 points. Let's go down to the Cats' dressing rooms now. Here's Dixie Marshall.
Sandy, I can't tell you any technicalities. Mal Blount has taken his players straight behind closed doors for that. I can tell you that there was fire in the eyes of the Cats as they walked in. There was plenty of pep talking, especially from some of the older players, whose main message was believe in yourself, believe in your teammates. As for Damien Burke, he's still behind closed doors with the doctors. He is in a lot of pain and he has suspected broken ribs. Michael Roberts in the Melbourne room, obviously there'd be a difference there.
Yes, a very, very positive Melbourne room down here with John Northey moving around his players. It was obviously a pretty tense sort of first half, and as you can see in the background, a lot of these boys are pretty tired. Obviously the back line's very tight, it's very creative in the forward line in at Melbourne. There's no real injuries to report down here, and Melbourne are in a very strong position.
Now a look at up-and-coming events on the Australian Television Network, and the 1989 VFL football season kicks off on March the 31st, and the West Coast Eagles will be bouncing back with a vengeance, at least they hope to, when they battle Essendon under lights at the WACA ground. Then on April 9, see the top shooters from the southern states as they compete in the Kmart Aussie Basketball Classic, and don't forget to check your local TV guide for all telecast times. We're going to take a break here from VFL Park in what's been a great game of football, and as we do, we'll take you out with a little football fact. See if you know this one.
This is where a quick kick out of the pack can
Wilson. Wilson out wide to Giles.
Melbourne have won two night series premierships in 1971 against Fitzroy, and here in 1987 when they beat Essendon by 4 points. They've been runner-up twice in 1969 and also 1970. Can they do it again tonight?
Melbourne centreman Brian Wilson has come a long way in football after a sluggish start at Footscray and North Melbourne. He joined the elite group of VFL footballers when he took out the 1982 Brownlow medal. The Victorian representative is a damaging player when he has the ball, especially in range of goals, and his bursts of enthusiasm are team lifting. Being on top in the centre is vital for team success, and an informed Wilson, even in his 12th year of VFL football, is difficult to stop.
Yes, Brian Wilson has been damaging again tonight. 9 kicks, 1 hand pass, and he's kicked, perhaps most importantly, 2 goals, 1 in each quarter. Well, as we contend with the wave here, gentlemen, 27 points, it's certainly not the end of the world for Geelong.
Well, I think when there's a low-scoring game, it's always the team that's behind are always a big chance. Geelong have been very, very ordinary, I think, in the first half. They just haven't got any value from the opportunities that they've had.
No, and I think you'll find, too, the two main forwards. Here we see Dwyer clashing with Burke down the ribs. I think they would be very sore. And I think perhaps if we could make a comment there, if it's worthy of comment, perhaps a little unnecessary.
Well, I would have thought so, but still the umpire let it go. And it will be a very, very big loss for Geelong because Damien Burke, a big guy, he's been replaced by a fellow who would be, I would say, 4 inches shorter than him.
Well, they've got to overcome that loss, but how else can Geelong get back into this game?
Well, I think their thrust forward, Sandy, have been okay, but they've broken down on half forward where Tony Campbell's done an excellent job holding down Christensen and his, beg your pardon, Stoneham. And Bill Brownis, while he's broken free a couple of times, isn't really as damaging as what we'd like. And their smaller players aren't crumbing as well as they should have from the Melbourne backman spoils.
How impressed have you been by Melbourne as we have a look at the statistics?
Well, obviously, they're on the statistics, Sandy. They're well in front, and particularly in the air with those marks. And they're getting better value for their shots at goal. And their tackling, whilst both sides are fairly even in their tackling, and it's been quite a red-hot go. But I think Geelong's tackling has come from being second.
All right, gentlemen, thank you very much for that. And as we look forward to the 1989 season, I can tell you also that we look forward to great competition on the Australian Television Network. It is a beauty. It's the top 25. And what we've got to do is find the top 25 since 1965, and that requires you to list in order your best 25 players in the past quarter of a century. Our football commentators already cast their votes, and you must match that list. And we're going to have more details on that as the weeks go by, but I can assure you it is one of those competitions that is going to be a talking point everywhere around the country. We shall take a break with a footy fact and be back shortly. Geelong's only night series premiership was back in 1961 when they defeated North. They've been runner-up twice in 57 and then last year when they went down to the Hawks. Can they get up this year? Had a pretty busy night picking up 9 kicks, a handball, but most importantly he's kicked a couple of vital goals, one in each quarter. Damien Burke has been a great tryer for the Cats. Look at that, 12 hit-outs, 8 in the first quarter, and sadly had to leave the ground in the second. Alan Johnson has been very busy for the Demons. He's picked up 8 kicks all over the ground and has also kicked a goal, which has been vital for Melbourne. Paul Couch, a prolific kick winner from the middle for the Cats. This time perhaps a little quieter. 5 kicks and 3 hand passes, has applied 3 tackles. And Simon Eichold of Melbourne, 8 kicks, a couple of handballs, and he's kicked 1 great goal as we get ready for the third quarter with Peter McKenna, Bernie Quinlan and Drew Morford.
Thank you, Sandy. And the second half about to get underway. Clear lead here to Melbourne by 27 points. And Geelong, of course, have lost their ruckman, Damien Burke. But Geelong win it out of the middle. Russell's there, just gets a kick in. Scott gave it away. to Spalding, long to half forward. And the crumbs read well by Besto. Straight up the centre of the ground. Huge pack gathering here. Stoneham over the top of O'Dwyer. No mark paid. Comes away to Bailey. His hand pass looking for Spalding. Beaten to it by Stoneham. He's had plenty of possessions at centre half forward. His kick up to the 50 metre line. 2-1 here in favour of Geelong. But Grinter gets back there to try and find the boundary line and does it successfully. Grinter claiming a free kick. A bit of a grin at the umpire. That con didn't work.
Horse Ahern is magic. Well, John Ahern went off towards the end of the second quarter. A vital quarter, this one, for Geelong. They really need a couple of quick goals. It'll be interesting to see if Ablett stays on the half-back line. McCrabb, been fairly quiet tonight. There's a hand pass coming out wide from Gary Cameron. Well, the Demons repel that attack again. And the mark has been taken by Newport. He's on centre wing. Very vital as far as Geelong is concerned. They don't let Melbourne score the first goal. That was Lyon diving. Still on that centre wing area as players charging in after. There's Bairstow brought to ground. And the umpire will come in and bounce it. First 5 minutes very important here, Bernie.
This is a very important quarter for Geelong. They must get back into this game. And this is a quarter that they must do it.
Bounced by umpire Clayton, out near centre wing. Crab wins. Comes to Buse. High towards the centre of the ground. O'Dwyer thumps down, goes to Gary Hocking. No man's landed half forward. Chance here for the Cats. White thrashes the ball out of defence. Goes to Russell. He wants to come inboard. Does it successfully, but a poor kick off the left. Rhodes there. Ball spills out. Denham going the wrong way. Lost it in the tackle, put it down. Melbourne's free kick. Bit of a box on going on afterwards. Umpire close handy, but everybody wanting to get involved. Never too far away, R. Grinter.
Well, Melbourne's tackling's been very, very good tonight. It's been a feature of Geelong's play in recent weeks. But Geelong, they've had, well, they haven't handled that ball surely at all tonight. They've fumbled and they've made a lot of mistakes. And that's due to the pressure of Melbourne. This is Aishol from half back. Out wide, McCrabb tries to hook it over the top. Oh, Ablett, once again, that enormous skill as he straightens up and kicks a long boomer towards full forward. Boundless and Cameron, they're falling down there. Here's Stoneham, who's playing well. Steps at the goals and this... Let him run!
Geelong using Michael Schultz in the ruck. And he goes up against O'Dwyer. Wins it too, comes down to Scott. Off the left boot to half forward. Stoneham trying to knock on. Spalding out of defence. Good gather by Bailey. Melbourne into attack now. Wide for Lyon, very wide. But he's in front of his opponent and takes the mark. Easily two kicks to goal from there. Lyon's kick just up inside the 50 metre line. Comes to the back of the pack to Healy. Snap for goal. Won't make it. Wilson's there with Scott. What a contest that was. And it's rushed through for a behind by Darren Troy, who came on after half-time.
Well, that was a great play by Robert Scott. He was caught right underneath that. 8-9 to 5-5, and the Cats are not out of this yet. A lot of people felt at half-time the game was all over. I wouldn't write Geelong off. There's Boss. Ah, to Ablett, who's showing his class tonight again. Gary Ablett, a top mark at half-back. Let's see how long he kicks this one. 55 metre kick towards half forward. Up they go, fisted away by Quinter. It hits the deck. Here's a chance for Couch. He gets it to Darren Troy. He's brought the ground. It's a free kick against O'Dwyer. Too high, and this is Darren Troy. Can they get another one? The Cats. The lead is on. Out comes Brownless. Oh, he's dropped the sitter. And although maybe that's being a bit harsh on him as it's hooked back by Stretch towards centre wing. Wilson hooking it towards half forward. Mark Yates is there. Can he control it? In comes Boss to lend a hand. There's two reliable players, if ever you've seen them.
Troy taps for Ablett. Well played, Ablett. He didn't have the ball grabbed by Bailey. Great play by Ablett. He's taken more marks than anybody on the ground tonight. Five marks coming up for kick number seven, as well as three hand passes. Long kick to half forward. Brownless underneath the ball. Pushed out. Free kick to Brownless. Now he's reported to be able to kick over wheat silos up in the country, but he won't need to this time. It's a 50-metre penalty, which will put Billy Brownless right in front. Just about a gift goal for him. And he should get number three here.
Well, they're back, right back in this game. Geelong all of a sudden, Drew.
That was very poor play there from Danny Hughes. Not getting that ball back. Here's a free kick. Free kick against Danny Hughes. Slight nudge in the back to Billy Brownless. And now that 50-metre penalty. He's only having this kick from about 15 metres out.
Margin 22 points. It comes back to six.
The contest now, 6-5 to 8-9. Geelong scoring the first two goals of this quarter. Michael Schultz going in against O'Dwyer. That's another free kick, but this time it's the other way against Schultz. He ran straight at O'Dwyer then. And Steve O'Dwyer, centre of the ground. Let's see if Melbourne can take it down and score a goal. Oh, the big fly. No mark. Kicked away by Boss. The Cats doing well now, but there's height. Far too much height there. Mark taken by Spaulding. He's gone wide. Very, very wide, in fact. 2-on-1 here in favour of Melbourne. Stephen Stretch has got it. The short one is on. Was meant for Newport. Applet ran into his back. The touch of the fumbles there by Healy. Now it's Simon Eichholt. He's surrounded by four Cats. And that's a good sign for Malcolm Blight to see players charging in after it. But there's a free kick on the Melbourne player. And it's a free kick to Ricky Jackson, who's on the ground about 40 metres out from goal on a 45-degree angle.
Haven't seen Ricky Jackson tonight. Spent the first half on the bench. There's no doubt about the free kick. Here it is against McCrabb. Much too high. Ricky Jackson to take the shot at goal.
Well, the short pass is on that travel about 10 metres. And Gary Lyon, who's a pretty good kick for goal, has marked on a better angle. But still will have to kick from about 40 metres. Eight kicks, three handballs, and he's looked very dangerous all night. He's already kicked one. And they could do with this one. Oh, it's off the side of the boot. And it's through for a point. So maybe things starting to turn Geelong's way.
17 points the difference. The half-back flank. Good gather here by Spaulding. Close to the boundary line and over it. On the full.
It's not a good kick from Merle Spaulding.
He should have sent it.
I think he's going to throw this in, but it was definitely on the full.
No doubt.
Spaulding should have centred that ball, got it in front of the goals and given the forwards a chance.
So a vital decision there. Melbourne still in attack here. Comes to Ablett. Starring at half-back. A long kick out of defence with not much run-up. Bounces over Stretch. It's wide open here for Geelong now. Gary Cameron off the left boot. Up towards half forward. Two against two. Bues an early climb, but no mark. Comes to the front. Campbell, well played. And now it's open for Melbourne on their forward line. If Healy can get this. But it beats him out.
Well, it's at half forward for Melbourne, and the tempo of this game has really been uplifted with Geelong making an all-out attack in this quarter. He scored the only two goals of the quarter. Here come the Demons. Oh, that kick was by Newport. Ablett, oh, he should have time to pick it up. He kicked it off the ground and put it out in the full, but he's playing a great game at halfback. Ablett.
Got three. Go.
Greg Healy. Captain of the Demons, that's a lovely kick. He centres it looking for Bennett. Oh, Bennett almost took that mark too. It's at half back as Couch receives from Yates. He gets it to the centre of the ground. This is Cameron wide to Scott. And here come the little Cats. With the short pass is on. Beautiful football. The Schultz and Scott. Too slow, Michael Schultz. And that's a... Oh, very, very... Oh, I thought he was caught red hot in that one.
The free kick was there, I'm sure. Schultz took off and then he was ridden into the ground.
Well, he's not too good either. But Burke's already off and Schultz has replaced him in the ruck. And he's not getting up in a hurry here.
Here it is again. Rode takes him. Look at that. Right into his back.
No doubt holding the ball.
Oh, no.
We might have more ribs here. This doesn't look too good for Schultz.
No, just see.
Well, they couldn't afford to lose him.
Okay, we'll just get him.
They'd really be a small side without Burke and Schultz.
Well, they haven't relied on their marking to beat Essendon or Carlton. They've been outmarked both nights, but have thrashed them.
They've been great at ground level, but he seems to be all right, Michael Schultz. Let's have a look at that. He's caught from behind.
Oh, he's right in his back, Peter.
Well, he fell out.
Rode him into the ground.
We won't argue with that. The umpire's played it to Schultz anyway. He's 60 metres out from goal, and a goal here would really lift the Cats as the kick sets it up for Brownless. Out he comes. Two bites of the cherry. Couldn't quite get there. Kicked away by Johnson. He's gone out wide. Oh, now, was that on the full by Campbell? No, it was very close, but it's out and over the line. Throw in to take place about 25 metres around from the Geelong goal.
We're nearly halfway through the third quarter and Geelong have taken just 17 marks for the night. Outmarked 27-17 and Ablett's taken five of those. Here's Ablett ducking his head into trouble. Lost it. Picked up by Grinter. His kick towards the centre. Healy sprints after this one. Oh, into his back. And Couch will take the free kick. That could have been wide open for Melbourne that time. So Paul Couch did pretty well against the odds. From just behind the centre. Poor old kick. There's a free kick. Melbourne free kick. Coming back to Jackson. Troy with the sit but didn't take the mark. Left Wilson unmarked behind. Brian Wilson sprints up towards the 50. Steers the pass to Bennett. Great play. And Darren Bennett, we've seen him kick before. This won't bother him from about 55 metres. And he is going for goal number four.
Watch your lines.
Mark Boz now playing on Bennett. And Yates picking up Gary Lyon.
Bennett, the former West Coast Eagle, actually kicking from inside 50, so it's no bother the distance. But this time he's missed it away to the right. So again, things not quite going Melbourne's way. Bennett with 3-2.
Well, that kicking could be very costly in the long run because they should really be a long, long way ahead, Melbourne, on the play. Yates has gone wide. Darren Troy is there. He's a pretty tough customer, Darren Troy. He's got it at halfback. He gets in the hand pass too to McCrabb. McCrabb cleverly wide to Mark Bairstow. And here come the Cats again. Jimmy Steins comes across the front. Can't take the mark. Here they are, though, with Stoneham. Could be a free kick to Geelong, I think. Yes, he was held there, the Geelong player, in Gary Hocking. Now, Hocking is at half forward. Where's Brownless? The lead is on. It's wide. And it's a mark. Now, Brownless will kick from 50 metres. He's one of the longest kicks in the league, Bernie.
He should make the distance from there, Peter.
Now, Billy Brownless has kicked three, and that's what he must do more of. He must lead at every opportunity.
That's too far up, Danny!
Well, what a vital kick this one is. You can see the 50-metre line. He lays back, and... Oh, it's close! And he's just missed. And Billy thought it was a goal.
And not for the first time tonight.
Yes, the second one. 6-6 to 8-11, but they've really picked up their game, the Cats.
White kicks in. Eyeshoulder has been in a lot of play. Good mark. Now it's got to come back to Simon Eyeshoulder.
Now that should not be 50 metres. What's that for?
It was Melbourne who kicked the ball away, not Geelong. And a 50-metre penalty for Eyeshoulder. So the mark now up on the wing. Touches the man on the mark. Here's Newport. And that kick just bounces in. And we'll have a throw in.
Lifted their game, Geelong, haven't they, in this third quarter? Especially with this captain off the ground, Damien Burke. I thought they would have been in big trouble in this third quarter, but they've shown plenty of spirit and they've fought back well.
Melbourne have added just three behinds for the quarter.
Well, the difference is 2-5, and that's not a lot in modern-day football. That was Spalding, getting it to stretch. Stretch, a clever kick to hook it back. Eyeshoulder's looked dangerous all night. Here come the Demons again. Oh, Yates went for it one-handed with the Cats. Rebound, this time through Paul Couch. He brings it towards half forward. There's no mark to road. It's a loose one, but it's a free kick to the Cats. And we go, no, they're playing the advantage as it's shuffled out towards Schultz. Michael Schultz has got a paddock to run in. He nearly lost it. He's going for the hand pass. Oh, bad hand pass to Brownless, who was caught. Still a chance, though, as we see Baldwin caught with the ball. Drops it like a hot scone. In went Danny Hughes, and they really messed that up, Geelong. And Michael Schultz should have kicked long to the square as it's out wide towards half-back. And Melbourne really let off the hook as Johnson gets it to Wilson. Now, was he in possession? No, said umpire Ian Clayton.
Well, that's twice Michael Schultz has been running up to the forward line and didn't quite know what to do with it. Wilson short pass to Bailey. Just over 8.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Melbourne 8-11, Geelong 6-6. Blocked in the pack. Schultz bowled over. Denham to Bairstow. Over to Ablett. Ablett standing start, a 50-metre kick. Oh, beautiful play, David Cameron, on the front edge of the square. Brownless leads again and got it on the 50, but he dropped it. Oh, it comes back to him. Billy goes for goal. And has missed it.
Yes, very fortunate to end up with that ball then, Bill Brownless. Danny Hughes had given up the ghost. He knew he had no chance of getting anywhere near Bill Brownless, and he dropped what he should have taken.
Well, he's doing the right thing at least now, Billy, and leading, and that's what you must do on Danny Hughes, because Danny Hughes, in fact, is off the ground, injured, hobbling, and Johnny Ahern is on. Oh, that's a good mark. All Spalding, a very, very good mark. He brings it to half forward. Ahern at the back. Couldn't take the mark. It's a loose ball again. Taken for Geelong by Gary Hocking. He kicks it straight up near Ablett underneath it. Let's see if he ends up with it. It's McCrabb, in fact, going to get it. And the bounce of the ball now going Geelong's way. As it comes towards Stone, it's fisted away. Good play that was by Gwinter to get it to Steins. But McCrabb's in the way again.
Jim Steins reads the play well, considering he only picked up the game about 4 years ago. Gwinter can't take this mark. Goes to Healy. Beats a tackle. Bailey taps over his head for Newport. Good play by Stephen Newport, but his kick's touched. Bewes, oh, a bit of ballet there. Great stuff. To Yates. And away go the Cats up towards the centre. Gwinter. Congested centre half forward. Wilson with a big climb. Yates knocks away. Newport too slow. Robbed of it. Goes to Troy. Chance here for Geelong now. Bairstow through the centre. Measures off the pass to David Cameron. He's with Rode. Brownless comes in to apply the tackle, but the player didn't have it, said the umpire. Actually, Billy Brownless has given away a lot of free kicks.
Well, that should be, if the umpires are consistent, that should be 50 metres again. Because the Geelong player...
Now, Danny Hughes off the ground, Michael Roberts.
Melbourne fullback off the ground, and they've iced his left hamstring.
So Melbourne, after the free kick, bringing it up the ground. This is Ahern. And Yates sees the ball out. Half back for Geelong. 16 points the margin, and we have just over 6 minutes left to three-quarter time.
The ball right in front of our commentary box here at VFL Park on half-forward flank. About 75 metres around from the Melbourne goal. That was Ahern with a big fist, but waiting over there is Paul Couch, who hasn't been as dominant as normal. He's gone for a wobbly old punt kick. Steins couldn't mark it. There's Schultz crashing his way through. He's lost it. Oh, cleverly kicked away from Steins. Stoneham brilliantly out wide. This is Dwayne Russell hooking it back. Now, Cameron's got to wait underneath this one. Sean White, the big fist. Who will it come to? It's come to Bairstow. He runs to 50 metres. He's straightened up. A chance at the back. Is it a goal? Poster. Oh, that's three for the night for Geelong.
Yes, they're looking good though this quarter, Geelong. Melbourne haven't kicked a goal this quarter, and they've really struggled up on that forward line. Sean White now playing fullback on Billy Brownless with Danny Hughes off the ground.
Geelong this quarter, 2-3. Melbourne just 3 behind. So a margin of 27 points. This looks like Alan Johnson, who might have gone down behind the play. Meantime, a good mark to Ahern. Still back in the back pocket. Kick by Ahern. Not far past half-back flank. Bairstow knocks to the front. And shuffled out to Jackson. Away to Eichold. Pass to centre wing. McCrabb's there. Comes off to Troy. Back to McCrabb. Pretty ugly as he went in. In the back. And free kick to Earl Spalding.
Well, it's at centre wing. Poor play there by Darren Troy. He really was slow to get rid of that ball.
Must hear Duke.
Earl Spalding. Real battler for Melbourne. Nice looking kick. Oh, that could have been a free kick to Lyon. Oh, good play by Yates. Couch. Here they come again. Bairstow in everything in this quarter. Kicks long. Oh, Brownless was grabbed. Yes, and the umpires, I thought he had missed it, Bernie, but it was there.
Yes, well spotted by the umpire on that occasion.
Well, the official attendance, 48,720. So a great crowd here. I think this is too far for even Billy Brownless. He will have to kick from 55 to 60 metres. He lays back. What a long kick. A beautiful kick.
just offline and through for another behind, but it's all Geelong this quarter, Bernie.
Yes, and Bill Brownless has kicked three behinds this quarter. Had plenty of opportunities to really get Geelong back into this game.
Alan Johnson has recovered and looks as though he'll take the kick in. Actually roamed up from the back pocket earlier on in the first quarter and kicked a goal. He's got a bit of a wait for this ball to come back. Melbourne have just made a change. Ahern off and Stephen Tingay on for his first run tonight. Johnson's kick towards the outer side. Ball run over the top. There's Russell, number six, diving in after the ball. It's come out the back to Baldwin, but the umpire's going to ball it up. Just over 4 minutes left. And there's John Ahern on the bench for Melbourne.
Well, it's a half forward for the Cats. And they could really do with another one before three-quarter time, or maybe two. They've really dominated this quarter. The quick kick comes down. Ablett waits underneath it. It's a loose ball. Oh, here comes Ablett. Let's see if Gary Ablett can kick one of his boomers. He crashes his way through. Now it's a free kick. Oh, the umpire's paid the advantage and it hasn't worked. Well, I think he paid the advantage. It didn't work to Geelong's advantage. Then he gave him a charity free kick. But this is Ablett from 70 metres, kicking it long. Where's Brownless? He's hit the back. Can't take the mark. Here's David Cameron. He hooks it back over the shoulders, but he's missed. But, gee, they've really taken over this game, the Cats.
They have. Melbourne haven't done anything this quarter. They've only kicked three behinds. And they've struggled to get the ball down on their forward line.
And Geelong have kicked 2.5 goals, so they've wasted a lot of their forward opportunities. Eichel kicks away from Scott. Out on the full, was it? Scott has it, but the boundary umpire's going to take it off him and throw it in. Just under 3.5 minutes left in the third quarter. And Geelong have come right back at Melbourne in this turn. Baldwin paddles it out. Up to centre wing. McCrabb. Good kick on the turn. And Grinter bowled over by his teammate. Jim Steins, the ball out of play. So another chance for Geelong to get something out of this with time running out in the third quarter.
I don't know why the umpire's yelling there. There was nothing happening. Well, there's Steins at the back. Robert Scott dives on top of it. It's still at that 50-metre line. The Cats thought they could really do with one here. With just under 3 minutes of play left in the third quarter. Steins again against Schultz. And Schultz giving away a few centimetres there to Steins. Well done by Michael Schultz. It's tapped over the back to Eichold. He's gone for the safety of the boundary line and in fact has put it over.
The thing about Melbourne though is that they are a good defensive team, and even though they've won their last two matches narrowly, they have had the ability to stick on.
They do win a lot of close games. Well, 13 points the difference. Still at half forward for the catcher, but that fist takes it towards Healy on centre wing. Wilson's there. Bairstow's got it. Good tackling by Geelong as it brought back to the forward pocket again, but what a good mark. And it's taken there by Stephen Tingay. Or is it Alan Johnson? Alan Johnson, in fact.
And his kick up short of the wing. All Melbourne at ground level. Or Hocking did well to shoulder his opponent out of the way. And look at the fight after the ball in there. Eventually Melbourne get it out through Jackson and Wilson. Short of half forward. Yates straight after it, tries to keep it in, but the ball beats him out. It's been Geelong's quarter, but they haven't been able to get the points on the board. There's the acting captain, Damien Burke, on the bench. And I wonder if he's going to miss a lot of games at the start of the season, whether it might tilt the captaincy decision away from him. Up to half forward go Geelong. Gary Cameron keeps his footing. Beautiful pass, right onto the chest of Denham, and he's marked on 50. Brownless back in the goal square with White meeting him eyeball to eyeball.
Yes, Alan. Yes, Alan, I've got it.
Little man, this distance would test him. Cats really need it. Not a bad looking kick. Not quite. Brownless, nearly. Oh, still a chance. David Cameron. Still in play. Phoebe. Is he holding it? No, the umpire says throw it in.
Well, the camera showing that Dwayne Russell thought it was deliberate, but I think the umpire was right. It's deep in that forward pocket. Schultz again against Steins. Over the back, Stoneham was in there. Now a chance for Dwayne Russell. He straightens up, has a shot. But once again, they've missed, and really, they should be up with Melbourne at the moment, Bernie.
Oh, definitely. They've dominated this quarter. And Malcolm Blight should be pretty pleased the way they've fought back. The player who's put in a good performance this quarter, I think, is Michael Schultz, who's had to shoulder the burden in the ruck.
Kick in by White. Sprawling over the back. It was a push out. It's a Geelong free kick to David Cameron. 65 metres out. Short pass. A centering one to Troy. Didn't gain much ground. Very congested up there. Brownless itching to make a lead. Stoneham a jump at it. Johnson the hand pass out. Could be a Geelong chance here. Gary Cameron first there. Just gave it to Grinter. Now the ball's gone out and we'll have another throw in. And there's the siren for three-quarter time. A quarter in which Geelong hit back but kicked inaccurately. The margin now 12 points after they trailed by 27 at half-time. Melbourne 8-11, Geelong 6-11.
Cup and Melbourne hold their lead. It's not as great. 8-11, 59 to the Cats 6-11, 47. Ross, Geelong coming back. They had their opportunities, but they could be much closer.
Certainly could, Sandy. And with Bill Brownless, I think perhaps should take some of that blame, kicking one goal three in that quarter for a tally of 3-4. And with a better conversion rate, even just one of those goals, Sandy, would have given them a bit more of a push into that quarter. Now they're, 12 points behind. It's not that far to be behind, but they should be further, or should be closer, in fact, in front.
No doubt Geelong fans would have been disappointed to see Burke leave the ground, but the performance of Schultz was solid.
Oh, certainly he's come on. Obviously, Malcolm Blight's instructed him to be as physical as he can to try and upset Melbourne's push forward, and he's working very hard. He's had a couple of opportunities to take them forward, and he's just messed up a little, but his effort you can't query whatsoever.
Those statistics are from the third quarter only, but Geelong dominating in the handball section. Let's go down to the boundary line because the coaches have finished their addresses. Here's Dixie.
Sandy, a fairly predictable grand final three-quarter address by now. Much more up-tempo, Malcolm Blight. He used words like character, pressure, that sort of thing over time. He wants his players to be more direct, play this thing out long and hard. Michael.
Yes, John Northey reminded his players there's still a quarter to go and plenty of hard work. He wants the players to play the game that got them in front at three-quarter time, for them not to go too defensive. And I notice Rod Grinter has slight concussion.
So the scene is set for the final quarter. Here's Don Scott, Ian Robertson and Peter Landy.
Final quarter of the Panasonic Cup for 1989. Melbourne leading by 12 points after the Cats kicked 2-6 to 3 behind during the third term. And Geelong scored the last 6 points of the quarter from the 14-minute mark. Healy wobbles the kick up towards half-forward. Yates marked, but he did appear to push out an opponent. Yates from half-back. O'Dwyer in front. Has it knocked away from him? Oh, good tackle. That was by Spaulding. Couch from Eichold. Kick only travels about 15 metres, but the mark is taken by Cameron, and he's off. Now towards half-forward, Sean White. Strong out of defence, and that's a great mark taken by Spaulding again.
It's great play by Sean White, one of the only times Melbourne defenders have really attacked the ball on the back line.
Spawning from left half back. Goes down the flank. And the mark taken by Eichold, showing a little bit of temper. More frustration. Into the pocket. Off the hands of the pack and picked up by Newport. Plenty of Geelong defenders there. All leaving it for each other. Newport. And that is O'Dwyer down two behind play. Of course, he tangled with Damien Burke earlier, and Burke hasn't reappeared. O'Dwyer looks a little bit sick again, doesn't he?
Doesn't look too good at all.
Boundary throw in, left half forward flank for Melbourne. Let's see what happened. We have it on replay. Collides with the knee of Bairstow, it would appear. Back live, up towards midfield. Campbell tries to pick it up. Socket away by Phoebe, over the head of Wilson, looking for kick number 13. McCrabb will try and prevent him from doing that. Was the tackle high? Couch comes out with the ball and boots it back to midfield.
up towards the centre of the ground. Spalding couldn't mark. Good roving by Scott. He breaks clear and he gets the hand pass across to Gary Cameron. Gary Cameron's kick towards full forward. Good punch away by the Melbourne defence. Under pressure. Cameron again. Gary goes for goal and puts it through. We've got on our hands. Melbourne lead by 6 points. They were 27 points in front at half time. And Geelong just kept at their heels. O'Dwyer couldn't get the punch out. Now the advantage is paid. The free kick was to Melbourne. It's kicked towards centre-half forward. Lyon in front. Oh, slipping over Yates at the crucial stage. Lyon's kick around the corner. Here's a mark to Melbourne. It's taken by Grinter.
And Grinter's been moved on to the half-forward flank, but Eichhold now half-back.
Michael Roberts reporting that Grinter has slight concussion. Grinter's kick towards full forward is in short. The mark's been taken by Boss. He plays on quickly. Gets it out to Couch. Geelong running on. Couch is kicked towards centre wing. Spalding does the punching away. A good play there for Geelong by Baldwin. Spalding can't break away. Bairstow's there. Tackled by Grinter. All players now pretty tired. O'Dwyer's tap on. Gives Stones a chance. From the standing start, he's kicked towards centre-half forward. Five Geelong players. Now the crumbs come to Jackson. Scintillating pace by Ricky Jackson. Goes for goal. Hooks it around. It's home. No, it's not. Well, it must have been pretty close.
I thought you were right, actually. I thought it was a goal. Grinter off the ground. 7 points the difference now. We've had some thrillers in the Panasonic Cup this year, haven't we? A couple of one-point results. This one may turn out to be the same way. Who knows? Healy again, leading by example. Steins, the kick is short but effective. And the mark is taken by Darren Bennett, who's kicked three goals. Three, I think, isn't it, Ian? 3-2.
Well, we sing the praises of fellows that do play in front. When it's a pressure game, quick kick by Steins, Bennett taking the reward.
He'll get the distance. He's a great kick, this fellow, former West Coast Eagle. All clear. It's a goal.
Well, now it seems to be Melbourne's turn to come alive. And I suppose that's the way modern-day football is played. One team goes out of it, they lose the initiative. The other team comes in, and now Melbourne, well, they went to sleep really through that third quarter. And here's this quick one. Watch Bennett. Not a good kick by Steins. And getting in front again. And the good thing about Bennett, he likes to play in front.
That equals his best performance with the Demons. He kicked four in his first match. Was taken from the ground in the second one after he came out with the wrong boots, and he's got four goals again tonight.
Bailey's now been moved back to the half-back flank with Eichhold going into the centre.
66-53. And after the Cats got to within a kick, a worried Geelong bench. Can they come back again?
Come on!
Schultz and O'Dwyer. One by O'Dwyer. Couch out of the centre, up to half forward. Campbell in front of Stoneham, marks on the edge of the square. Looks for distance. And Lyon knocked away by Yates. Crumb gathering is Wilson. Healy, beautiful mark.
What about the roving of the pack by Wilson?
Alan Border would have been happy at first slip snatching that one.
What a great mark by Healy at full stretch. Watch the way, watch this. There he goes. What a magnificent mark.
They're desperate, the Demons. And they really want to stay in front. Greg Healy, statistics fairly impressive. Important kick. Deep in the pocket. He's kicked to the front of the square. It goes to the back. Touched. And it's a rush behind to Melbourne. So they lead by 14 points once again. And some fingernails being eaten right away there by some Geelong fans. And Boss to kick the ball in. The quarter. More, just about half over. Kick has been marked by Yates at half back. The ball will have to go back. Umpire Clayton.
Spalding should have gone the punch on that occasion. A lot of players nowadays don't seem to punch from behind.
Yates at half back now kicks the ball over the centre wing. Marking contest. The only player to stand his ground was Campbell, and he takes a fairly easy mark at half back for Melbourne. Kicks it long back towards where Yates had just kicked it from. Big punch away by the Geelong defence. Now's a chance for Hocking. Hocking's hand pass over the top. Ablett streaming towards centre-half forward. Kicks with the left foot. Over the top. Oh, great anticipation by White. The dasher out of defence. Will the ball bounce for him? He punches it further afield. It was nearly as good as a kick. He carried it 55 metres.
I think White might be injured. I think he might have done
gone.
A hammy.
Yeah, he's down.
Newport's kick towards half forward. The ball comes to the rear. Buse and Healy. Now there's a chance for Tingay. Tingay, left foot kick into the pocket. Wilson, can he gather the football? Kick off the ground by Bennett. Rolling in front of the square. Here's a chance now for Boss. Boss comes clear with not too much pressure on. Gets the ball to Couch. Couch has got pressure on, but he's up to it, and he kicks it in short. And the mark's been taken by, is it Bairstow? Bairstow, now the ball at half-back. Couch. Couch's hand pass out wide. McCrabb. McCrabb on centre wing from a standing start. Kicks it towards centre-half forward. No mark taken. Punched away by the Melbourne defence. Scott can't break clear. He gets the hand pass out. Russell tries the bounce. It slips at the very important stage. Good tackle by Campbell. Ball comes free to Spalding, and Spalding clears for Melbourne.
Stretch, left centre wing. And as Sean White comes off the ground, that bounces just inside the line. And quite obviously, Sean White has done a hamstring. You'll see him running here and pulls up pretty quickly.
Bang!
Happened right there.
But what a great effort to follow on. Well done, Sean White.
And at the same time that was happening, Simon Eichold was down with cramp. He's now back on his feet. Ball at the back of the pack for Troy. Denham. Kick is short. Just clear centre wing. O'Dwyer's there. Misses out to Russell. Right on the boundary line. Back across his body up towards the 50 metre line. Cameron. That's David Cameron. A knock on into the pocket. Going for the boundary line was Bailey. He didn't really try to find Adam Johnson. It'll be a boundary throw-in. Well, a hamstring usually means about 3 or 4 weeks on the sideline. Let's hope that that doesn't mean, though, that Sean's going to miss the opening VFL game.
Five, four.
We'll have some news on his condition shortly. O'Dwyer and Schultz. Over the top was Steins. Stretch has front position. Christensen did a good job keeping him quiet early. Eichold gained some ground, about 15 metres to be exact, and the ball up towards centre wing.
A lot of changes being made by the Melbourne side. Spalding now at the full-back position.
Malcolm Blight learning what coaching's all about tonight. Let's hope he doesn't pull any more hair out. I mean, he and John Northey have got that much to much left to pull out, have they? Free kick after the ruck duels. It's going Geelong's way. 12-18 left in the first, last quarter. Schultz's kick up towards half forward. Rode, an underground hand pass. The recipient is Healy. The captain goes long up towards half forward. Ahern might get the free kick. He was being held. He'll take it. Still inside the centre square.
Move it quickly. He does. Good long direct kick towards full forward. The mark's there. That's the advantage of kicking it long, direct and fairly quickly. Bennett's taken it.
There's something on behind play. Cameron and Stretch on half-back flank.
Nice old dust up that one.
Bennett has the football about 40 metres from goal. This could be the first nail in the coffin. Lovely long kick straight through.
Leap into Sports Go for footy boots like Adidas Addy, marked down to only $70.
Ablett, 9 points the difference now, still in favour of Melbourne. So a kick and a half, we might say. Knocked down by Schultz, albeit not very far. Trying to get clear was Newport. Phoebe finally socketed off the ground. A free kick is going Geelong's way. Let's see who's going to take it. The ball being returned to the centre. Hocking, who's certainly lacked nothing in courage tonight. Looks for distance up to the 50-metre line. Huge pack of players out there. Campbell pumps the ball well clear, looking for and finding Eichold. Move besides the boundary line is his best option. It'll be thrown in on centre wing. 8 1/4 minutes remaining in the match to the presentation of the Panasonic Cup. Will it be Melbourne again?
Look at it now! Look at it!
O'Dwyer and Schultz lock arms. O'Dwyer beautifully to Healy. The smother though from Denham was equally effective. That's the first touch for Fletcher tonight. Must be a free kick against Gary Ablett.
Great play by Bailey.
Oh, that's courage. But that's what you've got to do, Ian, in games like this, and they're match-winning efforts by, and that's Brett Bailey there. At least he's held up play. Had he have pulled up, the ball could have gone anywhere.
That's great courage shown by Bailey. He knew somebody was coming.
Bailey inside defensive 50. He'll be feeling pretty sore for a while. Over the top, Tingo tried to mark, which again is not really the percentage play, I guess, from the back. It looks spectacular. As Don said, players don't like to punch the ball. 7.5 minutes remaining in the match. Bounced down on centre wing. Fletcher nearly had his second touch. Socket away by Steins. Down goes Fletcher. Players going in with gay abandon here. Finally it comes out to Russell, showing a good turn of speed from right centre wing to right half forward. Looking for Brownless. Ablett out of bounds. Throw in right forward pocket for the Cats.
Well, and Gary Ablett could be the trump card for Geelong. Been switched up into the forward line. Played a tremendous first three quarters at half back. Boundary throw in about 35 metres around from the Geelong goal. Stoneham over the top. Now it comes out to Denham. Denham's kick is smothered off the boot and it goes over for another boundary throw.
Geelong certainly winning the ball close into those packs. They're getting it out of the centre and around the boundary line. A little bit more committed to Melbourne.
It's only 25 metres out from the Geelong goal. O'Dwyer and Schultz have had a tremendous battle. Schultz, credit to him, giving away centimetres. Punch out wide. And it goes over for another boundary throw. And it's a little further away from the Geelong goal, though. And Melbourne just inching further and further out of trouble. They lead by 9 points. And time ticking away. We've just received word that Stoneham has been reported, the Geelong centre-half forward. Ruck contest. Stoneham gets it out. Johnson, kick across the ground. Gives Phoebe the run at it. Hocking there. Phoebe, who can stand their ground? Phoebe does well, the youngster, and he punches it further away from the Geelong forward line. It's now wide on centre wing. Lyon perhaps could have given the free kick away. Hocking there again. Yates to help out. The ball comes to the back. Great play, Lyon. He handballs it. Tried to himself. Great Troy time. There backing up well. And Troy's kick puts Geelong back into attack at centre half forward. Who can gather the bouncing ball? Geelong come wide. Chance for Couch. He bounces when he was tackled. Runs into trouble. Good tackle by Healy. And no free kick awarded.
Well, you ask what's wrong with the kick, Don, don't you?
Well, I thought Couch at least had the opportunity to get rid of it. Should have got rid of it. The umpire should have pinged him for holding the ball. Must agree.
Bounce of the ball at centre half forward for Geelong. 9 points Melbourne lead by. Steins now doing the ruck work. Russell over the top. Stoneham can't break clear. He's been free kicked. He did not have the football when he was grabbed. And Barry Stoneham a chance for the Cats. Right on the 50-metre line.
You've got to get this one.
Can he make the distance? He's not a reliable kick.
That'll be close one way or the other. Two Geelong players fly. Schultz, did he come down with it? I don't think so. Neither did the umpire. Newport got a hand to block a Geelong hand pass. Did that very effectively.
Steady.
And umpire Ian Clayton will bounce it inside the kickoff area.
Melbourne should put this through the bound or through the goals and at least regroup and start again.
The Cats desperately need a goal here to stay in touch. Scott got a couple of hands to it.
Gee, what a struggle.
Oh,
great commitment, isn't it?
Yep.
Let's knock it out.
5 minutes exactly to go.
The whole series has been just terrific football, the Panasonic series.
Been the best of its type so far.
Oh, my word.
Closeness of the scores. The weather's been fantastic. Brownless got high. Snapshot for goal. That was by Scott, I think. Booted it. One behind. So Scott has kicked two goals, two. 74 to 66. Two goals the Cats need. They need them quickly. 4.5 minutes remaining in the game. Johnson goes to the outer side. Plenty of distance in that kick. The target is Steins. Knocked it on beautifully. The recipient stretch. Doesn't get that much distance with the kick up towards centre wing. Picked up by Buse. What's he doing down there? Wobbles the punt kick up towards half forward. Brownless has to beat a pack of players. Denham looks for his partner in crime, Scott. Not a good hand pass. Denham grab. The ball spills. Out to Bailey. And it's out of bounds. Taken away by Johnson. A throw in.
Gee, it's a character builder for the Demon defence, this, isn't it? They've really had to put in some heavy work.
There's one old-timer I saw today, Eric Guy, who criticised modern-day football, but he'd be pleased with us tonight.
Oh, you can't beat it. Tremendous stuff. Chance for Denham. Spalding, he's caught with the football. Gary Cameron, tackled by Campbell, Steins. A lovely little kick to touch by Steins, and it goes over for a boundary throw-in. It's still within goal-scoring distance for the Cats, so if they can get possession from this ruck contest, well, we'll go right down to the last siren. There's no doubt about that. Steins and Schultz. Schultz must be getting tired. Ablett, quick kick into the pocket. Johnson will see it over. And we'll have another boundary throw-in. It's only about 10 metres around from the Geelong goal, and with just under 4 minutes remaining, Melbourne lead by 8 points. 10-14, 9-12. What a tussle it's been all night. Ruckman again. Steins at the back. Over the top, Stoneham. Good struggle for possession. Now Scott. Snapshot for goal is high. It's close. It's a behind.
Some bad marking there by those Melbourne defenders. Those Ruckman shouldn't be coming up over the back. Campbell should be in front of Stoneham.
67-74. 3 minutes 20 remaining in the game. Johnson goes short with the kick. Bailey, a bit longer towards the outer side. Ushold was the target. Troy making it a little bit difficult for him. It'll be thrown in 65 metres from the scoring area. And the Cats need 2 goals desperately in 3 and a bit minutes. Melbourne defence has stood up well during this series. Campbell goes for the boundary line. Fletcher tried to keep it in. He was unsuccessful. And 2 number fours. And again, it will be thrown in right on 50. 11 Steins. A serviceable game again tonight. Campbell tries to pick it up. Healy finally does so. Goes for the boundary line. Rode.
And the other good thing, Peter, just casting your eye around the ground. Every man on the ground has got an opponent. Shoulder to shoulder. It's good stuff.
Not too many down the other end, Don. They're all at this end of the ground virtually at the moment. Schultz and Steins. Over the top is Phoebe. Doesn't bounce too well for Paul Couch. And again, it's out of bounds. Melbourne working it around the boundary line, albeit gradually.
So they're not very keen to keep it in, the Demons, no, are they?
But of course, time on being added. 2 minutes 45 remaining in the game. Melbourne closing it right up. And they're doing it very well. Couch's kick. Might have almost been touched off the boot. Stretch and Ablett. Both lost sight of the ball. Fletcher. Bailey's in there. Fletcher goes over the top of him. One could have argued that could have been a free kick. Booted away by Newport in the direction of Jackson. Now he's got Paddocks down there. Wilson marks unopposed. Could have gone on with it, but decides to retain possession.
So Wilson looking for someone to kick to. No one at home. In the pocket there is. The mark's been taken by Ahern. Off it goes to Jackson. Nearly caught. Gets his foot to the ball. Up towards full forward. And the mark's been taken by McCrag. He handballs. Oh, Geelong defence. The free kick's been picked out of it. In the back to Yates. Back in the right in the goal square. And Geelong a little lucky to get out of trouble there. Yates right on that full back line. Melbourne lead by 7 points with under 2 minutes left. Kick towards the centre-half back position. No mark taken. Wilson's quick kick. High in the air. He's been scragged as he kicks the ball. And the free kick may go back to Wilson. Inside the 50-metre mark. And this just about could finish it for the Cats. They're 7 points in arrears. And the time, that crucial clock, is ticking over. Wilson now. Very impressive statistics. 50 metres from goal. Drop punt kick. Close to the line. It goes through for a behind. So Melbourne lead by 8 points with just 1 minute 20 seconds left.
75-67 in the Panasonic Cup. 48,720 fans still glued to their seats. That will be kicked in again. Time on will be added.
It's quite obvious what Geelong are trying to do. Play the huddle. Stoneham coming down from that centre half forward position, creating for Geelong.
Cameron, Phoebe breaks the tackle well, gets it over to Hocking. Very hard to bounce on the spongy surface here at the park. Hooks it back towards midfield. The target was Bairstow. Newport gets scragged. An umpire Clayton, the advantage well paid. Winter up towards half forward. Beautiful tackle. Ball spills free. Kicked off the ground by Tingay. 50 metres out. Ishol. That could be the deceiver. Or will it be a free kick in the goal square?
Oh,
Okay, you heard that for Shepparting. Austin McCrabb will take the free kick.
How many times is the ball not within five?
Could have gone either way, Don. Peter Carey laying down the law to Steve O'Dwyer.
The umpires really do incite some trouble, don't they?
39 seconds left of the match. McCrabb goes straight down the centre. The only tactic for Geelong now. Schultz in front. Oh, great mark over the top. But Bennett, he's kicked five goals. Can he make it six?
Well, Steins is down with cramp. Healy's not walking around too well either. So Melbourne in a little bit of trouble.
I'd like to be on them, Don. With 25 seconds remaining, this guy kicks like a mule, as we heard earlier. And I'd give him a real chance of getting the distance.
One turn over, Mark.
He's gone the short pass. And it's on. Eichold takes the mark. And this will probably be the last kick of the match. Eichold.
That's it.
Melbourne will win. Only the margin now to be decided. Who cares? Because Melbourne have won the match. Eichold shot for goal after the siren. Looks like a behind. It is. And Melbourne win.
Well, Melbourne, they answered the challenge from Geelong. The Cats got to within a kick in the final quarter, but they just couldn't go on with it. And obviously losing Damien Burke before half-time was a very crucial part of the match. And Steve O'Dwyer and Jim Steins just proved a little bit too tall in the big man department. Schultz did well, and while the Cats had good little men in Denham and Scott Don, Burke's loss, he couldn't really be replaced.
No, but you mentioned Peter and you complimented Schultz on his effort. And I've got a second your remarks. But I thought it was a terrific game, as the whole series has been. And as you mentioned earlier, Peter, it's been second to none this series. I can't remember a really bad game. They've all been close. The players certainly have been committed. And they've really given football what it's all about. A real shot in the arm. Just commitment. There was everything in tonight's game. There was tough stuff. Players were going down. Committed players. They just ran out. And compliments to both teams. I thoroughly did enjoy the game and the series.
Yes, I must agree with you, Don. 9-13-67 Geelong. Going down to Melbourne. 10-16-76 in the grand final of the 1989 Panasonic Cup.
Now for the 1989 season, the Panasonic Cup Grand Final, a thrilling victory to the Demons as we go down now to the presentation area and VFL Commission Chairman Ross Oakley.
Ministers, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and it's great to see so many boys and girls here this evening. It's a great win for the Melbourne Football Club, 2 in 3 years. Congratulations. I'd like to especially thank the crowd tonight for turning out to this magnificent occasion. 48,000 odd people, thank you very much. It's made this a great event. I'd like now to introduce to you the Manager Corporate Advertising of Panasonic, Mr. Peter Binning, to present the trophy.
Ross Oakley, Chairman of the VFL, ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, commiserations to the Geelong Club. This is the second year as runners-up. Congratulations to them. This is very difficult for a Sydney sider being very nervous to present to Melbourne. That is, of course, the Melbourne Football Club. Congratulations to Melbourne. 2 years ago, I had the pleasure to present this trophy to Danny Hughes. This evening, it's my great pleasure, on behalf of the Panasonic Company, to ask Greg Healy, the captain of Melbourne, to accept on behalf of his club.
Well done, Greg. Congratulations. Yeah!
First of all, I'd like to thank the Panasonic Company for sponsoring this night competition. It's been a great success, especially because we won it. I'd like to congratulate all our boys for a good gutsy win. I'd like to thank all the coaching staff and all you supporters who came along here tonight. It's been great. Thanks very much. like especially send our best wishes to David Williams, who would have been out here tonight. Good on you, Dave. Bad luck to Geelong. We're going to have a big night. Thanks, Mum and Dad. You beauty.
So there it is, elation for the Melbourne Football Club. And whether you're watching this in Stanley in Tasmania or the north of Australia, we certainly hope you've enjoyed it. We've got plenty forward in a close, exciting, tense grand final. Victory going to the Demons, 10-16-76 to Geelong. Gallant in defeat, 9-13-67. So a fantastic game, and augurs well for the 89 season, which just gets underway in a couple of weeks' time. Gentlemen, could you wish for any better?
Terrific stuff, wasn't it?
Really was. Great game. Yeah. Great pressure game, and you look at the crowd that was here, Sandy, and the effort of the players all through the game with their chasing and tackling and their effort from the actual first bounce. And here we see some of the highlights here, the final quarter, where perhaps Geelong had their chances all the way through, but perhaps in that third quarter when they kicked 2-6.
I was just going to say the same thing, Ross, that they really lost it then, I think. They had a real chance to perhaps get in front. And I think it's amazing what happens if a side can, after battling very, very hard for the first half,
yes,
if they could have capitalised and got to the lead, it just may have been a different story.
I think I mentioned to Sandy in the three-quarter time summary where even just one goal out of those shots that end up being points might have given that little bit of lift coming to that last quarter. Then with another goal from, say, Ablett, as they did get, perhaps a little bit closer and gives them a bit more of a strike rate and a chance to get closer.
It was a little bit disappointing that Damien Burke, I guess some comments have been passed, that going off the ground, but I take my hat off to Schultz. I think Schultz did a tremendous job. He really tried hard. He kept putting himself in front. He got quite a few free kicks, and he frustrated both Steins and O'Dwyer, but I think it was perhaps the Geelong smaller guys that they did get the football, but they weren't allowed to break out into the open and get some sort of a flow going for the Cats to get the ball up on the forward line to kick easy goals.
Let's have a look at some of the stats, gentlemen, in this game. In the kicking department, Melbourne 188 to Geelong 170. The handball to Geelong fired out 71 and Melbourne 43, marking Melbourne supreme in that area. Free kicks, really nothing in it. Tackles going the way of the Demons, who really were ferocious tonight, particularly in that final desperate last quarter. Hit outs pretty close, 23 to Melbourne and 27 to Geelong, and we saw 5 50-metre penalties, 4 for the Demons and 1 for Geelong. Well, if you're a Melbourne supporter, you'll be celebrating tonight, and the Demons have made their way down into the rooms and are toasting a great win in the Panasonic Cup. We'll take a break and be back with plenty more action, including the Panasonic Player of the Match. Ground here at VFL Park, but you can bet your life there'll be plenty of excitement still in the Demons rooms. We'll be going down there shortly and also to the Geelong rooms. Let's have a look at some of the individual stats of the players who performed tonight, because there were players from both sides who did a grand job. Skipper Greg Healy coming back into the side, picked up 17 kicks, 6 hand passes and 6 marks, but wasn't too good on target. He booted 1 goal, 2 for the match tonight. For Geelong, Paul Couch, always a busy worker around the middle. 3 kicks in the first quarter, then 2, 4, and tried his heart out in the last to finish with a total of 16. Brian Wilson also 16 kicks, just the one hand pass. He kicked a couple of telling goals that were vital for the Demons. Moving on now to Barry Stoneham of Geelong up at half forward. He also tried desperately for the Cats to motivate them with 12 kicks, 4 hand passes, took a couple of marks, a couple of free kicks, and also booted 2 goals. Earl Spaulding was moved around a bit tonight by John Northey, but certainly didn't mind that. He picked up 13 kicks, a couple of hand passes, and 6 marks. And our final statistic tonight belongs to Sean Denham of Geelong. 11 kicks after a great start in the first quarter, in which he booted 6, 7 hand passes, and a couple of marks. Well, I said there'd be no doubt plenty of excitement in the Melbourne rooms. Let's go down to the Demon camp now, because I believe Peter Landy has big Jim Steins. Pete?
Thank you, Sandy. Yes, Jimmy, congratulations. Finally winning a big one at VFL Park.
Yeah, it's absolutely brilliant. You know, like, we lost last year, but we made up for this year. And being fantastic start yesterday, it's just time to celebrate.
From our side of the fence, it looked a pretty physical game. Is that how it was out there?
Yeah, it was, yeah. But everyone, like, on the ground, the whole 22 that were out there, they just put in all day and just never let up. And just, you know, we just kept at it and we won.
What really won it for you? You had a pretty tough personal duel with Damien Burke early.
Yeah, I think the guys like that were told to play, do a certain job, like keep players out of the game and so on, they did their job. And other guys, they were runners, they just kept running, and the forwards kept tackling and the backs kept punching behind. All the little things, and it just came off, and we just hung on in there and we won it.
It's been a pretty warm day. Was it very draining on yourself?
Yeah, it was pretty dry out there, but you know, in the mountain up, but you know, I don't know. It's just great to win.
You're among friends here. How are you going to celebrate tonight?
Oh, well, we're going to have a few beers, that's for sure. Maybe for last night, because we didn't have any last night, so you know, it's time to celebrate.
I think we'll sign off here, because we're just about to get crushed, Sandy. We might take it back to you, I think.
All right, thank you, Pete, and well done to the Demons, and good luck to Jimmy Stein celebrating tonight. Well, having seen now the entire Panasonic Cup, gentlemen, gee, we're going to be set for a big year. What have you been able to assess from sides' performances in this Panasonic Cup, particularly these two sides, and, of course, those sides they played in the semi-finals?
Well, I said, Sandy, to Ian before that you would have thought that Geelong perhaps had a better run to this game with their two bigger wins, but perhaps that doesn't really set you in the right mood for a final. Melbourne battled through their three games, won them narrowly, won them well, and perhaps that set them better for this game tonight, and I just wonder whether that gives them better run into the season this year.
Are the cynics going to say, Ian, well, perhaps Geelong, they're very good in March, but...
I think they showed a bit, actually. Yeah. I think they showed a bit of character. We get back to tight games. Good sides win tight games, and Melbourne have proven it. They've played a lot of really good, hard football over the last 18 months. All of last year, they showed a lot of character. Only they fell down in class in the last game of 1988. Darren Bennett is going to make a big difference. I don't think very much has been mentioned of him this evening. He kicked five goals, they only won by 9 points, and I think he's going to be a big plus for them throughout this season. But Geelong, getting back to the Cats, I think Malcolm Blight has got them doing the right thing. They're playing more direct football. They perhaps just overused handball at the crucial stage. They were always trying to get the ball up in the forward line quickly. And Brownless is a plus. Gary Ablett is becoming more adaptable, and I think they've got a lot to look forward to.
Would you continue or retain Ablett in defence?
Well, I don't think that they're too concerned about where Gary Ablett plays. I think Malcolm Blight will be looking for flexibility, players to be able to play in more than one position and swap them all around. If they're flagging in one position, swap them around and perhaps give them a job at the other end of the ground.
All right, gentlemen, well, now let's have a look at the Panasonic player of the match, and it certainly was a split decision, but a decision has been made, and this particular player picked up 15 kicks, 6 marks, 3 handballs, and kicked 1 goal. His name is Gary Ablett. As we go down now for the presentation, he's with Drew Morford. Drew?
Thank you, Sandy. Congratulations, Gary. A top game, but, gee, 2 years in a row, a narrow loss in the grand final at night.
It's a bit unfortunate, but that's football. You know, you've got to be in front when the final siren goes, and if you're not, well, that's the way it goes. So.
And late in the third quarter, you kicked 6 behinds in a row. If you'd made a couple of those goals, the result would have been different.
Yeah, well, I guess bad kicking's bad football. So Melbourne, you know, they made the most of their shots, and I suppose we're under a lot of pressure. The forward line was very crowded, so yeah, that's the way it goes.
Did it give you itchy feet when the forwards were kicking inaccurately and you're back in defence?
Oh, well, you know, as I say, that's the game of football. It's, as I said, there's a lot of pressure, and the forward line was very crowded, so it's very hard to get a clear shot at goal when it's that crowded, so that's the way it goes.
Well, you thrilled us as a forward, and you've been fantastic in this Panasonic Cup as a defender. Are you enjoying half-back flank?
I'm loving it, actually. A bit more freedom, yeah, it's good.
That's good. Well, Gary, as our Panasonic player of the grand final, a losing team, hopefully it's some consolation to you. It's an excellent prize, and we'd like you to accept this on behalf of Channel 7 and Panasonic.
Thanks very much. I'd just like to thank Panasonic. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Good on you, Gary. Have a good season.
Well done to Gary Ablett. Perhaps some consolation after the Cats went down again, but they can hold their heads high. It really was a great game, and once again, our congratulations go to the Demons. So there it is. The Panasonic Cup is over for 89 now. The real business will start in a couple of weeks' time. In fact, March the 31st, the home and away matches get underway, and we certainly look forward to your company for the 89 football season this year on the Australian Television Network. For now, on behalf of everyone involved in the coverage of the Panasonic Cup, this is Sandy Roberts saying goodnight to you all from VFL Park.
Should feel it together forever. This has been a Seven Sport presentation for the Australian Television Network.
Sevens Football 89 was proudly brought to you by Holden. CUB, one of the world's great brewers. Gillette, the best a man can get. And Panasonic, even more than you expected.